and she the law, and she know I'm the ball, and she know I could hide above the law, and she know I'm wrong, she know I'm from the street, and all she want me to do is fuck the police, talking about
when I get up all in ya, ooh, we can hear the angels calling us, and we can see the sunrise before us, and when I'm in that thing, I make the body slide.
We got done. I said, lady, what's your number? She said, 911. Emergency only. Head doctor perform surgery on me. Yeah, and now I'm healed. I make her wear nothing but handcuffs and heels. Then I beat it like a cop. Find the king, baby. Yeah, I beat it like a cow. Beat it like a cow. Ride the king, baby. Say, I beat it like a cow. But I ain't trying to be violent, but I do the time, but her love is timeless. Mrs. Officer, I know you wish your name was Mrs. Calder, huh? Like a cop call.
When I get up all in ya, ooh, we can hear the angels calling us, and we can see the sunrise before us, and when I'm in the thing, I make that body sing, I make it say.
And that was Lil Wayne, Mrs. Officer. I love that song. Hello, everyone. It's Jennifer Tapiero, your radio girl, coming to you guys live. Yes, we're live because I've been so sick for the past few weeks. Thank God we're live. Right? Thank you, guys. Thanks so much. We are live out here at the LA Talk Live studio, holding it down right by LAX Airport. It's about 80 degrees, tank top weather, flip-flop, short skirt. That's what I'm wearing. I'm describing what I'm wearing today. Anyway, I'm really excited. Thank you for checking out StarCam Radio. We have some special guests in the house, celebrity guests. I did a movie with him called Mansion of Blood, but he also has about like 15,000 movies coming out. Let's welcome actor Matthew Ziff.
Thank you.
Yes. And she's best known for playing Kara in American Reunion. Let's welcome Ally Cobran. Woo!
Hello.
Hello, guys. How are you? Good to see you both.
Good. How are you doing?
Fantastic. Did you guys come together or?
Yeah.
Same car?
We drove together.
In the Bentley or
in the Jeep.
On the Jeep.
In the Jeep.
How cheap of you.
I know. Next time.
You came to LAX Airport in a Jeep, but was it faster? Or, I mean, I would think the Bentley would be a little bit quicker.
It would be, but the roads are so many potholes on the way. It's
Oh my God.
We went for the bumpier route.
We did.
Was it fun? Jeep.
Sure.
It was off-roading in LA.
What kind of Jeep is it?
It's a Wrangler.
Nice, fancy.
All lifted and done up. And
okay, but you could have been driving in the Bentley here. I mean, what is it like driving around California? Because you're not originally from LA. So is it fun driving around and doing a little, like doing the tourist thing, you know?
Yeah, I think when I first got out here, I did a lot of the touristy stuff and sort of got it all out of the way. So it was really cool because I'd never done any of it before. Oh. But now anytime I come out here and I have friends that who haven't been to LA and come and visit, we do all the touristy stuff over again.
A lot of traffic in LA. Well, speaking of traffic, so I was watching the Hollywood episode of American Idol. Actually, I'll hold that thought. Let's go to the caller real quick. Hello, caller. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from? Hello, caller. You're live on StarCam Radio.
Caller.
We'll talk about that later.
All right. Bye, buddy. Well, anyway, so I was watching the live episode of American Idol, and, you know, it's crazy. Nicki Minaj was late. So they open up the show. Ryan Seacrest is like, welcome to American Idol. We are live and we are on time. And then they cut to the judges' chairs and it's Randy, Mariah sitting all poised and nice. And Nikki's missing. And then there's Keith Urban. So they made some jokes that she was stuck in traffic. She might have been
traffic
on the
405. Traffic was really bad yesterday.
Was it bad?
Were you
on the road?
I was stuck on the 405. I never get on the 405. Rookie mistake. I have been in LA for a long time. And it was like, I just moved here. I got on the 405 at 6 o'clock. I was afraid I would never get off.
Okay, so Nicki Minaj wasn't being a diva then.
She was really not being a diva. Traffic. I bet she was on the 405. It was awful.
Ah, because she was late, and then all of a sudden she sneaks in, and then they cut back to it, and then there she is with
there.
Sunglasses with a black hood. It's like, as Nicki Minaj's biggest fan, I love all her outfits. You couldn't get dressed up for the night, the big night.
I bet she like missed her wardrobe, missed her hair makeup. I bet she missed the whole thing.
I was thinking, was she sleeping?
They
did the alarm
just,
not
like,
go off?
They threw her in there straight out of the car.
I know. And they all seem really pissed off about it. Like Randy was like, you're going to, like he was giving her dirty looks. Even Mariah was like smiling at her. And it looked like she didn't do her hair. Keith Urban had better hair than she did. And then all of a sudden, you know how they have the Coca-Cola cups on the table? She knocked over the cup.
Oh, that's amazing.
There's nothing in there.
There's
Coca-Cola
nothing in it.
And Ryan goes, what's in that cup, guys? And he's like, maple syrup. Like, you don't know what to say. And she's like, scissor. No, do you know what scissor is? It's like what all the rappers have been drinking. I'm not drinking it. I'm a rapper, but I don't
real?
Drink it.
I thought it was just something you rap about. Like scissor.
No, this is something you mix. This is like something when you have bronchitis, like I had, and you mix it with your cocktail, like your water or your iced coffee, and you become crazy and you start rapping like Nicki Minaj.
What?
So
what?
Let's get some of that. Let's do that now.
Yeah.
But
do you
I
have
mean,
any of that on hand?
But that's not good though for kids. Like I feel like it's just not like
kids, don't drink that.
Seriously, but it was so embarrassing. Like, I bet you Coca-Cola is so pissed off because here they have, you know, them thinking that they're drinking Coca-Cola and she knocks it over and it's empty. Empty cup.
And you think one of them would have had the thought to say, oh, we drank all our stuff already.
We finished
already.
That
no,
shit.
We finished it. No, they have to say scissorps in there.
I know. What's in your cup, Matthew?
Water.
Okay.
Water.
Such
is
a lie. There's totally scissorp in there.
There's
He's
totally
lying right now.
Yeah, all
right. I love it. Well, it's good to have you guys in. Let's make sure that our followers out there are following us on Twitter. And what is your Twitter, Matthew?
It's at Matthew Ziff.
Okay. Do you go by Matt or Matthew?
Matthew.
Okay.
Mostly. Whatever.
Okay. And Allie,
not
what's your Twitter?
At Allie Cobrin.
Awesome. And, you know, by the way, for our fans out there, you can call us up live and talk to your favorite celebrities. It's 323-247-7443. So that number is 323-247-7443. I noticed you laughed when I said celebrities.
Oh, no. I was laughing because I remember the last time I was here that you had the in sync saying the phone number in sync.
Oh, with Josh?
Yeah.
He doesn't work for
I
us anymore.
That.
Remember that?
I'm sorry.
So we don't do that anymore.
We're not going
to
talk about that, Matthew.
Sorry.
All right. Well, let's talk about the careers. You guys are blowing up, doing a lot of stuff, a lot of big things. I mean, your IMDb. I was like really impressed. I mean, seriously. Okay, Matthew, what do you have coming up? What should the viewers expect?
All right. Well, I did a film called Treachery, and I co-starred in that with Michael Biehn, who's Aliens, Terminators, a whole bunch of fun stuff. I just got word that the edit is done, just about done.
Oh, nice.
And they're going to go to film festivals pretty soon. We're going to the Sunscreen Film Festival in St. Pete, Florida.
Is that Sundance or Sunscreen?
Sunscreen.
Okay.
This is Sunscreen.
Where's
Sundance.
That located at?
It's in, I think it's St. Pete.
Okay.
Yeah, St. Pete,
okay.
Florida.
Okay.
And that should be pretty fun. I know, right?
Pretty Sundance, cool. Who do you play in that? Who's your character?
My character's Nathan.
Nathan.
And I play Michael Biehn's character's name's Henry. I play his son.
Cool.
Yeah.
Was that cool playing his son?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. He's like, he's an intense guy. He's
like
really
Gary Busey,
cool.
Right?
No. Nothing like Gary Busey.
Oh, never mind. Wrong movie. Mansion of Blood. Wrong movie.
Hopefully that'll be out soon.
Hopefully. Do you have pictures of it? I mean, I had a special picture delivery like about a few minutes ago. And
those are from the next film that I'm doing. We're working on producing
this is like
a film
slideshow.
Called,
we can just do like this and you look like you're moving.
a film called Six Gun Savior. It's a supernatural Western. Working on it's
can you sign that for us or?
Yeah I can okay. Ooh, that's a good okay. Shot I don't think I ever
Allie,
saw that
want one?
One
yeah
want
please
one? Okay you
yeah.
Get one of those
yeah I'll sign that
I'm auctioning
right
these off
hang it up on my wall.
You would put this on your wall Allie would you put that on your wall
sure
why not seriously
right. But we're working on that right now. We're almost done with filming. We got like I think six more days and we go into edits and all that, and it's gonna be really fun fun production.
Can you sign this for us? I mean, you know, you're a big shot now, you know, playing Michael Biehn's son and all. And Allie, you have so much going on. I mean, you're best known for your role in American Reunion, and you have, like, your IMDb, too. I mean, the list goes on and on. You've been acting since you're a young girl. What do we have coming up for everyone to see?
Next up are a couple different independent films. One is called Girl House.
Nice.
Which is about a bunch of girls in a house.
Oh, wow.
Hence the title.
Matt is really excited. He's like, oh, wow. All of a sudden, this chair moves, like the voice. And also he turned around. He pressed that button, and he's like, oh, you're chosen.
That's a horror film that should be coming out late this year. That'll be fun. And then I also have a little drama called Monica.
Oh, nice.
Where I play Monica. And the titles of these movies really tell you what they're about. And that's about a couple on their way to LA, make it big. They have the big dreams, you know, becoming an actress and a director. They get sidetracked. Drama kind of ensues. The girl Monica has. I'm so bad at pitching movies, by the way. This is why I act in them and don't like try to pitch them.
You're selling. I got it, girl. I'm like, I'm sold.
They're on their way to LA. They're in Texas, and there's drama, and she's trying to help her dad, and this couple doesn't know what to do, and unfortunately, they turn to stripping. She has to. Yeah,
you have to be a stripper. Clubs.
Yeah, but I have great stripper buddies. Carmen Electra's in there with me.
No way!
Wow.
Again.
There you go.
It's gonna be a really fun movie. Yeah,
that's nerve wracking. Cool. I mean, did you get nervous? I mean, of course, when people go see it in the movie theaters, you just watch it. But there's a whole camera crew there. There's the sound guys.
Right.
I mean, I did a love scene, and it's awkward. All of a sudden, the sound guys come out of nowhere. They want to work all of a sudden.
Yeah, yeah. It's like everyone wants to work as soon as someone starts taking off some clothes.
Where'd you come from? Craft service guy? Okay.
Exactly, yeah. I don't know. Luckily, we had a lot of time to prepare. We were training with some Cirque du Soleil chick that, like, taught us how to do the stripper moves and the pole dancing and all of that. So by the time we got on set, it was like second nature.
How does it sound to you, Matthew?
He's really excited.
I'm going to stay out of this conversation, but
that's so cool. And you're working alongside Carmen Electra and stuff. What was she like? I actually interviewed her. She's very nice.
Yeah, she's super sweet. She's kind of exactly what you expect her to be like. Just like super friendly, super nice, and like awesome.
She's a good actress.
She's a great actress.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's awesome. She's a great dancer, and now she's singing, which is awesome.
Is this because she's dating Simon Cowell?
I heard they broke up. Yeah.
And they're still, I'm sure she still has a singing career because Simon buys his like ex-girlfriend's houses, cars, singing career.
Oh, okay.
She's good to go.
Okay.
She'll be taking Nicki Minaj's spot in American Idol next time.
I'm sure. But yeah, no, Carmen Electra's awesome. It's great.
That's exciting. And then also Monica, who you play the lead character.
Yeah.
You have to carry the whole film. A lot of pressure's on you.
Yeah.
So how do you get into a role like that?
Luckily on this one I had like a full week to prepare. Sometimes you get a movie and you're like on set the next day, but I had like a week, and I think I sat in my living room with like the entire script laid out, just kind of like working hours on end, and then running over to the studio to have stripper lessons. Not kidding. I kind of prepare movies like one would a play. Like I make sure I have the whole thing kind of together in my head before walking onto set for a scene, because of course it's so out of order and you're like filming breakup scenes on day one, and then
Matthew's like, I'm gonna see that movie.
I'll see the movie, why not?
It's gonna be in theaters. Where can we check it out?
Not sure yet. Probably do the festival route, and then we'll see from there.
Awesome. Well, call us up, everybody, all of our fans out there. The phone number is 323-247-7443. We're going to be talking movies. I also want to hear more about the movies that you're going to be doing. And I have these pictures. Who's this girl right here? Is she just a random extra on the set? Or?
No, that is Miss South Carolina.
And she's in the movie as well? Or?
She was stopping by to hang out and check out the set. And she's a very, very nice person, beautiful woman, and starting
Matthew's
to be acting.
Is that his ex-girlfriend?
Starting rumors. I said next girlfriend.
We should start some rumors.
Let's just start rumors.
And who are these guys right here? Because this set looks awesome, by the way.
So
are you shooting a guy, or is that fake? Or?
Do you know who that is?
I have no idea.
That one's me.
Now who's that guy in the hat? We have a caller.
Oh,
hold that
caller.
Let's go to the caller real quick. Caller, tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
My name is Ali. Call from New York.
Hi, we have a New Yorker in the house. Welcome. We have Matthew Ziff in the house and Ali Cobran. Do you have any questions for our lovely guests? Hello.
Hi there.
Hi. Do you have any questions?
Not at all. I just want to tell Ali Cobran she's beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Aw, that's very nice. Do you have any questions for her? I mean, she's sitting right near us, so you can ask her anything you like.
Any other movie she's going to be in? I mean, I haven't seen her since American Pie 2.
Well, hopefully many, many movies in the very near future, but this year Girl House and Monica should come out. And there's also another movie that I did we didn't talk about yet called Beautiful Now that will be coming out in the very near future, too.
Are you a big fan of hers?
Yeah, I kind of fell in love with her after American Pie 2.
He fell in love with you.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Well, awesome. Well, we appreciate you calling in. Tell all your friends
well,
to check it out.
I appreciate you picking up the
phone. Of course. You're lucky. I mean, seriously. Well, tell all your friends, yeah. And if they're an Ali Cobran fan, then they can call us up.
All right, we'll do. Thanks
all
a
right,
lot.
Retweet. This is LA Talk okay. Live, StarCam Radio. And follow me on Twitter as well, at Jennifer Tabiero. Bye.
That was an excellent question.
He's like, I just want to tell her she's hot.
Hey.
I'm from New York.
There you go.
How you doing, buddy? Well, I appreciate that. Well, we're going to take a break. When we come back, more with Allie and Matt. Matthew, actually. I want to call you
Matt.
You're the
one. Call me Matt. It's all right.
It's easier. Right. We're back with Ziff.
Ziff, yeah.
We'll be right back. And that's Lil Wayne. Talk about popping something. Where at? Where at? Can I just stick his key up in your back, so this club so packed, these girls so drunk, this club so packed, these girls so drunk, this club so packed, these girls so drunk. I got a bottle, got my money, and I stuck it. And the thing is slow motion, like so slim, come around, wipe it down like bullshitting. I bet a thing up for me, and show me that you love me. If it's really too much for you, you can bring a couple buddies. And every day I do my thing, big stones and chains. She let me drill all in her mouth, no Novocaine. Your mother cat broke, that's all they did for told you. Thing. I can put you on that G4 and show you things. I like my woman fat booty, pretty toes and things. Long hair, don't care, long as none down there. If it's manicured, I can have fun down there. Take you to whatever club, throw some money in the air. This club so packed, these girls so drunk. This club so packed, these girls so drunk. This club so packed, these girls so drunk. I got a bottle, got my money, and I stuck it. Get high, get high, get high, get high, get high. Westside, 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 Westside. Young Moolah, baby. We having a celebration, let us stay high. 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 Blowing on that hail, hail, breaking down them trees. I'm out the door with that on them peas. Scooping up Chris and I'm hitting the freeway. Yeah, got a whole zip of that perk. Got a couple home with no clothes on. Get a roll on, let's twerk. Got we hotboxing that ghost. Ace all in that dough. Ray-Bans on my face. Never know when my eyes low. Smoke good. Good. Eat good, stay cash. She said backwards, kill switches. UE, take out. Yeah. But I love and red bone. She country thick and that hair long. That killer, she dead wrong. She went to high with her hair strong. Her mama tossing her legs long. She went to college and got a master's. Now she bringing that bread home. Roll up.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk. Are you ready to enjoy the Maui lifestyle? You can have it all by owning real estate on the Paradise Island of Maui. Dennis Rush, a 22-year Maui resident and real estate broker, brings his wealth of experience and market knowledge to add value to your Maui real estate understanding, providing a level of service as unique and exceptional as the island of Maui itself. The magical island of Maui was voted the most exclusive resort island in the world by Condé Nast Traveler, and keep in mind, Maui is only a simple nonstop flight away. Hawaii Business Magazine Top 100 Realtors awarded Dennis Rush the 2011 fourth top realtor on the island of Maui. Go to www.dennisrush.com to view all of the amazing properties currently available in the Maui MLS system. Whatever your needs or desires, Dennis Rush will provide a private consultation for any Maui properties your heart desires. You will be in good hands. Once again, go to www.dennisrush.com. That's www.dennisrush.com. Contact Dennis today to start your Maui lifestyle now. Dennis Rush, proud sponsors of the Dawn Christie Show and LA Talk Live.
That's a fact, that's a fact. Don't act Hollywood, cause I don't act by my business, but I don't slack. This my celebration rap, so
we having a celebration, let us stay high. We having a celebration, let us stay high. We having a celebration, let us stay high.
Welcome back to StarCam Radio. Let's go to the caller really quickly. Hi, caller. You are live on StarCam Radio. Tell us your name. Where are you calling?
Hi there. My name is Jason Checker. I'm calling from Los Angeles, California.
Awesome. LA, how are you? Are you calling for Allie?
Yes, I am calling for Allie.
Awesome. Well, we have her in the studio with us live. Any questions for her?
I just wanted to know what has been her biggest, the best advice she's ever gotten.
Boy, this is a real question. The best advice I ever got was when I was like 13 years old, a dance teacher, his name is Joel Hall in Chicago, told me there's going to be a whole lot of no's. And then he like stood up and started like lecturing me. And he was like, no, 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 no. But there's going to be one yes every so often. And that yes is going to be amazing.
I love that. It's so true. A lot of no's out here. But you have to have like that thick skin, you know, and handle the no.
Yeah.
Because there are yes right around the corner.
Totally.
Any other questions for Allie?
That's all. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Allie.
Thanks, Jason.
The guys love you, obviously. We're going to have a lot of dudes calling
in. I love the guys, too.
The dudes are going to be calling in. Well, for our viewers out there and our male fans, are you single? Are you in a relationship? Or
I am single.
Okay, cool. So our fans out. I mean, Matthew, you're single, too, right? Perfect. I feel like I'm Patty Stanger right now on The Millionaire Matchmaker. Setting this shit up. I mean, they love you because of your awesome role in American Reunion. You went through some crazy scenes, you were saying, off when we were on break. Tell us about, you know, just, of course, being on the set. I know when you were younger, you were a big fan of American Pie.
It's
so being
true.
Casted in the movie, how did that feel?
It was kind of hilarious because I feel like I learned what sex was from American Pie.
Oh, thanks, Jason Biggs.
Thank you, Jason Biggs, which probably is, like, not the best way to learn what sex is. But it's true. That's what I did. And I was, like, 9 years old. And I was
9 years old learning about sex.
I know, right?
Oh, my God.
I was watching the movie with my older brother and all his friends. Was, like, not supposed to. Getting to work with all those guys was just so surreal and so bizarre. I remember when they were introducing me to themselves, they were like, Jason was like, hey, Jason Biggs. I'm like, I know, Allie Cochran. And but it was great. I worked with everyone in the movie. If you saw it, you knew that I was kind of like, at one point, just carried through the entire...
You were the drunk pass out girl, right?
Drunk pass out girl.
Awesome.
Yes, and just carry it throughout the movie. So I got to, you know, have little moments with, like, everybody.
Any making out scenes?
No.
Nothing? You didn't get to make out with Jason Biggs?
I didn't get to make out. No, I tried. I mean, I was all about it. Like, my goal in life as that character was to get Jason Biggs to take my virginity, and he wouldn't do it.
He wouldn't do it.
He would not do it.
Okay, if you could have had anybody casted in the movie, like your favorite actor, who would you love to like have a make-out scene with?
I don't know. I'm a little bit into James Franco. I'm gonna put that out there.
Oh, did you see Oz?
I did. He was so
cute.
Good.
He was really good. I saw that yesterday.
Yeah.
What was the best part of that movie? Because I thought he was fantastic.
I thought he was amazing. I thought everyone was great. I loved it. I'm just like such a sucker for Wizard of Oz and Wicked, and now, you know, Oz the Great and Powerful. Every side of that story I love.
You know, I really like James Franco because he's so down to earth.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, I actually interviewed him once and he was just laughing the whole time. Like,
oh, I love it.
I was like, I don't know if you're a stone buddy or like,
he was
drinking
funny. He was drinking scissor.
I don't know if he thinks I'm funny or like,
scissor, yeah.
He was drinking the scissor. I love it. So I'm pretty excited, though. You guys have so many, like, big things happening. Maybe a future collaboration. Maybe you guys can work together.
Yeah.
We're writing something.
You're writing working on something.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so Matthew, what else do we have? You know, the IMDb, you have like 5 movies in pre-production.
Yeah, I have a bunch in pre and a bunch in post, so everything should be going all at once. Oh, I'm getting, sorry.
Oh, are your fans tweeting you?
They are.
Matthew's blowing up right now.
He's blowing up.
Ooh.
Are you guys maybe texting each other?
Yeah.
Our ideas for our next movie.
You guys are writing together. Well, what would be like a piece of advice to like young actors out there? Because it's not easy. Like you said before, your role model or your teacher said no, but you also get yeses.
Yeah.
What would be some piece of like, what would be just some inspiration for people out there that want to be in the business?
Keep going.
Yeah.
Keep trucking along.
A couple years ago when I first got out to LA, I met Patrick Dempsey just in passing.
Where was that? The Grove or?
No, it was at Beverly Hills Hotel.
Fancy.
Yeah, and I guess I was staying at the hotel there and he was there. I think there was something there and I don't remember what it was, but he was there and he was walking out and I went up to him and I said, hey, I'm a big fan.
You fangirled him.
I did a little bit. I don't care, whatever. And I said, do you have any advice for a young actor trying to make it in LA? And he said, oh, something I'll never forget. He said, never give up. Never give up in your dreams.
I love that.
So
yeah. That's smart.
Someone told me when I first moved out here, this reminds me. He said, you can't fail. At this, you can't fail when you're trying to pursue a career in entertainment. You can only quit. So until you quit, you have to keep going.
Yeah.
And the only time you fail is when you quit. So.
Yeah, what we like to call it the grustle, the grind hustle. Keep grustling. Thanks, grustling. Richard. You hear me out there? But yeah, like keep on the grind, you know?
Yeah.
And it's hard because people do say no. You know, we just have to be like, all right, but the next person's going to say yes to me, you know? And keep the eye on the prize because I feel like a lot of people just give up really quick because they can't handle it. Like, do you guys feel like there's like a certain type of person, you know, that like you have to be a certain type of person to live out here in this craziness?
You really got to be, determined. To stick in the business, you got to really be determined. But I think to live in LA in general, and if you guys have a different opinion, say it. But I think you have to be able to see through a lot of things because a lot of people in California, I mean, I'm from Jersey. They're not like, there's a lot of fake people out here. And you really got to know what's real. Take everything with a grain of salt. And just know that. Nothing happens till it happens.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Al, you're from Chicago, so you know it's different being from Chicago and then living here.
Totally.
What are your friends saying back in Chicago? Do they, like, email you on Facebook?
Yeah.
Or the people that, like, the girls that were mean to in high school, they're like, hey, Ali, big fan of.
High school's a whole other story because I went to a weird hippie art high school. So, like, there were not the mean girls or any of that, you know. It was, like, the dancers were cool, the musical theater kids were annoying, and, like, the artists were, like, interesting and cool. Yeah, what were we talking about?
No, like anybody hitting up now is like.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's really fun, honestly. I just went home to Chicago and I was like, wow, quite the ego boost. Everyone's like, oh my God, how are you? I saw you in this, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, this is silly.
You're like, you were mean to me. Now you're nice. Do people ever Matthew, do people ever Facebook you like asking you for stuff?
Yes.
Like I find now lately, like people that were like, they never talked to me. Now all of a sudden I'm getting friend requests and hey, do you know an agent? And I'm like,
I've gotten a lot of, well, a couple of things. I've gotten a lot of people because I went to a boarding school. So from my town that I grew up in, like middle school, and I didn't really keep in touch with most of the people there. So I've seen things that people are writing about me, but not to me, writing to each other about me. And I'm just like, and some of them are now kind of burnt out and it's just funny. But some people are actually like, we're like genuine, like, hey, you seem to be on the right track. Do you have any advice? And I've been very helpful there. But the one thing that's been a little strange that I found, I've gotten a lot of because on my Facebook for acting, I just accept everybody that requests me. I'm like, okay.
You accept everybody?
I have four of my acting stuff. I have I just accept everybody.
I Google
on there.
Everybody I add nowadays.
Yeah,
because it gets creepy.
Yeah, creepy. And I've gotten. I mean, maybe it's different because I'm a guy, but yeah. I've gotten messages from people asking, like, from abroad, like from different countries, asking for me to sign a picture and send it to them. And I'm just like,
oh, send them this one.
Yeah, right. I'll find a find one of these and I'll do that. So. No, but I think I sent one to somebody, but I don't think I've done, I don't know. I find that strange. I
think it's very flattering. I would take that as a good sign that things are going in the correct direction.
Yes. Otherwise, I mean, if you're getting hate mail and they're like throwing eggs at you, that's probably not a good sign.
Yeah.
Matthew was saying you guys went to the Grove and a bunch of fans like came over to you. What does that feel like? Is it overwhelming when fans are like saying, I love your movies and stuff?
I usually don't get like, I love your movies. I get people just like guys just like kind of staring at me and I'm like, okay, I get it. You saw me with my shirt off once for like a brief second.
Oh, you had a nude scene. Ah,
yes. So, it's usually like just some awkward and I'm like, eyes up, buddy. No. And then,
that's hilarious.
And then we go on our merry way.
I love it. All right. Well, we're going to take a break. When we come back, let's talk more about some crazy fans. Okay. And we also have this poster that your father brought for me. Thank you very much, Dadager. This is StarCam Radio. We'll be right back.
That I should have bought you flowers and held your hand. Should have gave you all my hours when I had the chance. Take you to every party, cause all you wanted to do was dance. Now my baby's dancing, but she's dancing with another man. Although it hurts, I'll be the first to say that I was wrong. I'm probably much too late to try and apologize for my mistakes, but I just want you to know, I hope he buys you flowers, I hope he holds your hand, give you all his hours when he has the chance. Take you to every party, cause I remember how much you
Bruno
loved
Mars.
Things.
I feel for you, buddy. I mean, seriously. Oh, that's such a good song. Oh, man. He sounds like he had a really. He should have brought that girl to the party. I mean, geez. Bringing the girl to the party. Would have kept the girlfriend. All right. Welcome back to StarCam Radio. We're here chilling with Matthew Ziff and Allie Coburn from American Reunion, everybody. Big round of applause. And Matthew Ziff, you're from how many movies? Let's see. The list goes on and on. Okay, so before the break, you were talking about crazy fans and stuff.
Yeah.
Who are you guys, like, really big fans of? What celebrities? Who would you get starstruck? I mean, if they were sitting right here, who would you die over?
I geek out over really random people at random times. If I, like, saw someone do a role, and I'm like, oh, my God, I thought they were amazing. Like, this is so random. But the other day, I was at the movie theater, and I was walking out, and I saw Lucy Punch. Do you know who she is? I know her from Bad Teacher, and I thought she was so Lucy amazing. Punch. She was hilarious.
Wait, with the red hair?
Yes.
Oh, my God, she's so funny.
She's
she was great
so
in that movie.
Funny. She's so funny. And it's usually female comics that I, like, do a double take. I'm like, oh, my God.
Did you get a picture with her?
I didn't even talk to her. I got really awkward, and she, like, I feel like knew that I was, like, checking her out. And then I was like, okay, I'm going to go up to her and be like, big fan. You're awesome. You're hilarious. Keep being funny. And then I didn't say anything, and then she left.
Oh, you should have did that.
I know.
That would have been cute. Matt, what about you? Anybody?
Nathan Fillion.
Who is that?
He's, he was in Firefly.
Okay.
And now he's on
Castle.
Castle, yeah.
Ah.
He's one of my favorite actors. Anybody that's been on Doctor Who, probably, also.
Awesome. All right, by the way, fans out there, you guys can call us up live, talk with Allie and Matthew Ziff. It's 323-247-7443. We're going to take callers right now. So this is your chance, guys out there, if you want to talk to Allie. Ladies, if you want to talk to Matthew. I feel like I'm on American
Anybody
Idol.
Anybody, if you want to talk to Jen.
1-800-274-3525. Keep them in the competition. Keep them in the competition. I still can't get over the fact that Nicki Minaj was late to American Idol yesterday.
I think it's amazing. It's so hilarious.
She doesn't give a shit.
That actually happens. Like, a show's going to go on live, and you're like, crap, I'm not there.
And she wasn't even dressed up. She had the hoodie and all.
It's amazing.
They probably just, as soon as she got there, they probably just threw her on stage.
They're like, they shoved her in there.
Get on stage.
You know, the wardrobe. Isn't that the best part of being like an actor too? Like getting styled like on the movie
those
set.
Those 2 hours before you start working are very important. Yeah. I'm sure that's why she was like in a god awful mood. I mean, those 2 hours
she was pissed off.
They're ego boosting. They are pampering. It's great. You need that. I don't know.
Sitting in the makeup chair, is that exciting too?
It's great. It's just getting pampered and relaxing, and you're getting paid for it.
Have you ever had a really bad makeup artist? You're like, wow, that's a little too much.
I don't think so.
No.
I'm trying to think.
Oh, I have. I was like, oh, thank you very much, Mansion of Blood.
Yeah. Yes.
I was like, I don't need all this MAC makeup. Yeah. I'm not Ricky Martin. Like, seriously, let's not put all that makeup on me.
I've been pretty lucky, and maybe it's just because I'm a guy, but they don't put makeup on me.
Oh, you have good skin. Okay, showing off. All right, let's go to the caller really quickly. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from? Hi, caller. You're live on StarCam Radio.
Hello? Should
we call him back? Callers, by the way, the phone number is 323-247-7443. Hit us up right here at the LA Talk Live studio. We got another caller? Oh, we're calling the caller back. Okay.
Caller, we're calling
caller,
you.
Caller, we're calling you.
We're going to get you.
I'm going to prank call him.
Prank call him.
Hello?
Hello.
Hello, buddy. How are you?
Hello?
This is your biggest fan.
Who?
This is StarCam Radio. Your biggest fan? Talking business?
What is it?
StarCam Radio, your biggest fan. LA Talk Live with Matthew Ziff, Alec O'Brien. Your biggest fan? Business? Hello?
You still there, caller?
Oh,
caller! We're just having fun, caller! It's okay.
That's what I do in my spare time, everybody.
Makes prank
calls. I'm serious. No, I really do.
Alone it's on pathetic. Saturday nights.
I'm not even kidding.
Oh. I'll hang out with you, girl. You don't need to do that.
I literally, like, will call, like, Indian restaurants, and I will put in applications for this one guy that has been on my show. I think it's
You're
doing
so
him a
Jersey.
Favor. It's giving him business. What do you guys do in your spare time?
Oh, man.
I have a cat. I spend a lot of time with my cat.
Okay, what kind of cat?
She's Siberian, and she's beautiful.
Really? What's her name?
Her name's Kitty.
Kitty?
Kitty.
Oh, I love that. She's like,
I mean, it's a cat. Like, you know, she's still a kitten, so she can go by Kitty. I guess as soon as she's, like, older, she should just be called Cat.
Cat. With a K or a C?
C.
C. Just call her Cat.
Keep it simple.
Do you have any dogs, Matthew?
Yeah, I have a yellow lab.
Really?
He's 10 now. He's gigantic.
Oh, my God. I'm a proud mom of a new puppy, actually.
Very nice. Aww. Very nice.
Long night spent waking up at 4 in the morning feeding her and playing with her.
Aww. I remember when my puppy's about that big.
Okay.
He'd wake me up in the middle of the night, come into my room, jump on my bed, and just wake me up in the middle of the night.
Ah, well, let's go to the caller real quick. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
Hey, this is Mike, and I'm giving a call. I just wanted to talk to Ms. Ashley.
Sure. They want to talk with you, Allie. I'm sorry. Can you say that one more time?
Yeah. How did you put in the same chair?
Karen American Reunion.
It was crazy working with all those guys that I feel like I knew my whole life was super crazy. Just being thrown into that set with that atmosphere and those people that had been around working together for years and then getting to be a part of it. It was awesome. Thanks.
All right, we got another caller. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
Nope. Apparently we don't.
Nope, we don't have another caller. But if you guys do want to call... Call us up, 323-247-7443. Talk with Matthew Ziff and Allie Coburn from American Reunion. It sounds like you were in the movie too, you know?
I know, right? I'm not in the film. She is.
You guys got to do a film together. Maybe you guys should just date. You guys are super good looking, super talented.
I don't date younger men.
Oh, you're not a cougar? I'm a cougar. My boyfriend's younger than I am, so it's like... You don't date younger guys?
No.
I highly recommend it.
Okay, maybe next one will be younger.
Maybe you can add it to the bucket list.
Add it to the bucket list.
You never know. What kind of guys do you normally date?
Old lately, men or?
Cats?
Cats.
Dogs.
All over the place. Lately, I've been, I've had that actress syndrome. I've been dating my co-star. Yeah. Uh-oh. But it's going to stop. It's definitely going to stop. I'm not, it's...
Can you tell us who? Can you, like, name drop, or...
Oh, yeah, I mean, it's no big deal. At American Reunion, me and the kid that played my boyfriend in that, Chuck Hittinger, we were together for a while.
What's his name?
Chuck Hittinger.
Okay.
And then Monica, the guy who played my fiancé in that, Robert Hoffman, we were together for a little bit.
So all you guys gotta do is do a movie together. That's it.
But, excuse me, I have made it through a movie on set with an on-set boyfriend that we did not end up together. And this, it's going to stay that way. I've decided that I don't need to date co-stars.
Okay,
anymore.
What is it? Is it just because of the chemistry? Is it because you guys are always together?
I think it's just easy. It's like, oh my God, we have great chemistry together. Yeah, no kidding, because you did a chemistry test and a casting director was like, excellent, you guys are great.
It's like a matchmaker.
And then you find out that they're crazy and they're like psycho stalkers.
Yeah, well,
stalkers.
Just like, if you have fun on set, you probably should just leave it on set.
Well, let's go to the caller real quick. Let's see what they think about that. Caller, tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Newry, Maine.
Very nice. You calling in for Allie or what?
Yes, of course.
Any questions? The guys are ringing off the hook right now. The callers are just...
Is she blowing up right now or what?
Yes, she's blowing up. Any questions for her?
I just wanted to talk to her about her acting career, actually.
Cool.
What do you want to know?
What do I want to know?
Mm-hmm.
I just want to know if it's worth all the BS that comes with it. Because I'm an actor myself, and there's a lot of, I used to live in LA for a little bit, and it was tough. So I was just wondering, like, how she dealt with, like, her adversities, moving through those. And
yeah, I feel like, you know, everything in life is kind of difficult, so... Just because, like, acting could be kind of tricky, like, I think, you know, whatever you're, if it's hard, it's probably worth doing. So, you know, I don't get jobs all the time, and then every so often I do get a job, and it's amazing.
Yeah, keep it up, buddy. I mean, don't give up. Do you live in L.A. or live in Maine?
I'm just trying to stay positive about it and, you know, see what happens in the future.
Yeah, are you on IMDb? We'll check you out. Are you on Twitter, IMDb?
I'm on IMDb.
Okay. What's your name?
Alex Snell.
Alex Snow?
Yep.
Okay, we'll check you out. Any big projects coming up?
Yeah, not really. Not really.
Yeah.
Now,
he built up. Yeah. Not really.
Yeah.
Any, do you play lead background in anything?
Going on right now.
You don't have any lead background roles or anything I can be on the lookout for? I'm just
kidding. Not right now, because I'm kind of in between moving to L.A. and staying here on the East Coast in Boston.
Awesome. Well, we appreciate you calling in. We're right by the LAX airport. Maybe we'll see you at the terminal one day.
See us when you fly over.
Yeah,
we'll see you when you fly
Boston.
In.
We're kind of small right now, so.
Well, we wish you the best of luck.
Ben Affleck's doing a good job representing Boston.
Oh, yeah, he is. You're telling me that.
Absolutely.
I interviewed him twice. Go check it out if you're a big fan of him. He's really...
Yeah, he's doing really well.
He's really something else. Well, congratulations, Boston. Allie, you'd like to say anything to your biggest fan?
Just keep going, buddy. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of no's, but there's going to be a yes, and it's going to be awesome.
All right, thanks so much. Thanks for calling in to Smart
Cam
Radio.
Allie,
see you soon.
Take care.
Got to give it to him, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, give him credit.
Seriously, we probably will see him at LAX Airport.
Close enough. Or he'll see us as he flies over. Just look out the window to the right side of the plane as you go.
Oh, like any big plans? Yeah. Not
no.
Really.
Oh.
Yes.
That's all right.
No.
Hey, you know what? It takes a lot to call to one of these shows.
It really does.
Last time I was here, when the girl didn't want to call, but her mom called for her.
Oh yeah, she wanted to talk. She was like your biggest fan.
It takes a lot of courage. I don't know. If I wasn't on the show, I don't know if I would call in. Would you?
I've called in to radio shows before. I never to talk to people. I used to like win tickets or something. Right. I've never won.
Did you ever win?
No.
You never won.
And I've tried so hard. Just the other day in the car, I was in traffic and it was like 15 minutes and you can win tickets to something. I don't even know what it was. And I was like, might as well.
Start dialing. I always do that.
Yeah. I mean, it's worth it. What if you did win?
My mom actually won something, I think. Or no, actually she was like 98 and it was like 90. You're supposed to be like 99. I was like, damn it. Ugh. I always try to. I actually prank phone call radio stations all the time.
I am sure you do.
You would.
Yeah, I do that in my spare time. Saturday nights by the phone. Anything you'd like to say to your fans out there, Allie?
I want to say thank you to all my fans. I've recently been getting like lots of messages on my Facebook page and Twitter and stuff like that. And it's really awesome that so many people have seen my movie and like it and want to reach out and like say nice things. It's great. I appreciate it.
Awesome. And what's your Facebook and Twitter if we can just, you know, we want to be in contact with you?
Facebook, I think it's /Allie Cobrin. Twitter is @AllieCobrin. Instagram is AllieCobrin.
All right. Well, big round of applause from Allie Cobrin from American Reunion. Come on, everybody. Big round of applause.
Thank you.
Come on.
Get a plug for yourself. Come on, it's okay.
Clap for yourself, girl. Clap for yourself. And Matthew, if we want to be in contact with you, if we want to follow you on Twitter and Facebook, where can we find you?
It's Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. It's all at Matthew Ziff.
Or they can find you on this poster right here.
Oh, boy. Oh, yeah. We brought this for you.
Is this for me or is this for the show?
This is for you.
Thank you very much.
For the show, too.
Thank you.
I don't know. So.
Treachery. Cool. Awesome. Yeah. Can't wait to check you out in this movie. This looks dope. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And anything you'd like to say to your fans out there?
Just same. Just thank you. Thank you for everything. Really.
Thanks for being stalkers. Thanks so much. But we really appreciate you guys stopping by. Did you guys have a good time?
I had a great time.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Well, tell everybody you're chilling with Jen on StarCam Radio.
All right.
Tell them.
We're chilling with Jen.
We're chilling with Jen on StarCam Radio.
Awesome. You weren't going to tell them that.
Well, I... Yeah, I was.
Matthew's not a team player.
I know. What the hell?
I totally am. Whatever.
Well, next time I'll see you guys. It'll be on the big screen. So we'll see you soon.
See you soon.
All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we have T. Brown in the house. I mean, this guy just did a mixtape with Malik Youssef. He's Kanye West producer. This guy's dope. We'll be right back. I'm Jen Tapiero. I think that's the cue, Dane.
Excuse my charisma, vodka with a spritzer, swagger down pat, call my name Patricia, Young Money Militia, and I am the commissioner, you don't stop easy cause the F is my finisher, so misunderstood but what's the world without enigma, two bitches at the same time, synchronized swimmers, got the girl twisted cause she open when you twist her, never met the bitch but I fuck her like I missed her, life is the bitch and death is her sister, sleep is the cousin, what a family picture, you know father time. We all know Mother Nature. It's all in the family, but I am of no relation. No matter who's buying, I'm a celebration. Black and white diamonds, segregation. Up the fish, my money up. You just honey nut. Young money running shit, and you just runner ups. I don't feel I done enough, so I'ma keep on doing this. Let's go to a young tuna fish. Yeah. I'm going back in. Okay, I lost my mind. It's somewhere out there stranded. I think you stand under me if you don't understand me. Had my heart broken by this woman named Tammy. But hope gon' be hope, so I couldn't blame Tammy. Just talked to moms, told her she the sweetest. I beat the beat up, call it self-defense. Swear man, I be seeing through these shits like sequence. Think they heathen, pow, pow, the end. Talking to myself because I am my own consultant. Married to the money, f*** the world, that's adultery. You foolish, just you close your mouth and let your ass talk. Young money eating, all you haters do is asshole. Stop playing, check out this game on deadbolt. Mine so sharp, I fuck around and cut my head off. Real nigga all day and tomorrow. But these motherfuckers talking crazy like they jaw broke. Glass half empty, half full, I'll spill ya. Try me and run into a wall, outfielder. You know I'm a ball till they turn off the field lights. The fruits of my labor, I enjoy them while they still right. Stop playing. I do it like a king do. If these animals, then I'ma have a mink soon. Tell them bitches I say put my name on the wall. I speak the truth, but I guess that's a foreign language to y'all. And I call it like I see it. And my glasses on. But most of y'all don't get the picture unless the flash is on. Satisfied with nothing. You don't know the half of it. Young money, cash money.
Paper chaser, tell that paper, look, I'm right behind ya. Real G's moving silence like lasagna. People say I'm borderline crazy, sort of kinda. Woman of my dreams, I don't sleep so I can't find her. You is a gelatin, peanuts to an elephant. I got through that sentence like a subject and a predicate. Yeah, with a swag you would kill for. Money too strong, pockets on bodybuilder. Jumped in a wishing well, now wish me well. Tell him kiss my A, call it kiss and tell. Yeah, word to my mama, I'm out of my llama bean. Don't wanna see what that drama mean. Get some drama mean, llama scream. Hotter than summer sun on a Ghana queen. Now all I want is hits.
Yo, what's the deal? Medical Herbs for You, located at 7122 Reseda Boulevard, Suite 207-91335, Reseda, California. Give them a call at 818-666-8080. Make sure you mention the gift you received from mentioning the show, Dane's World. That's the location. Go be a patient.
Hey, hey, shout us out. What's the count? I'm your host, Ferran Dozier. I'm inviting you to join me on WDC Radio every Monday at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time as we discuss community topics around health, sports, and entertainment. So don't forget to shout us out. What's the count? On WDC Radio, only on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, or watch us on Ustream.tv. Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk. What's the count?
Welcome back to Star Cam Radio. That was Drake's Marvin's Room. He sounds so sad in this.
Man.
Poor guy. Well, welcome back to Star Cam Radio. We have some major celebrities in the house. Join me live in the studio is Tyron Brown, who is a rapper, songwriter. Got this new mixtape coming out with Malik Yousef, who is a Kanye West producer. Mixtape, hard work. Can't wait to check that out. Welcome to the show.
Most deaf. Thank you.
Bye. And joining him side by side is D Knight, his producer, songwriter, entrepreneur.
D Knight.
Welcome. How you guys feeling?
We all right, man. I'm off this little. I'm buzzing off this wine, feeling like Jersey Drake.
That rosé, Ricky Rosé. Oh, money. All right, I'm really excited because I listened to your mixtape. I'm obsessed. I've been playing it a lot.
Appreciate
I like that red carpet song.
That's
my theme song.
Want to know something funny about that, though?
Tell me.
I wrote that song. Remember I told you you did the interview with me and Malik at the ASCAP Awards last July? They, like, my team, they wanted me to write a blog about that because that was my first time doing, like, a major red carpet.
Uh-huh.
And when I wrote the blog, he had sent me a beat like a month before that I didn't know what I wanted to do with. I wrote the blog while I was listening to that beat, and then it reminded me of
our Red Carpet interview.
Yeah, not what it reminded me of that, and it reminded me of a conversation I had with one of my friends that lives out here. She's trying to be an actress and she's struggling with that, and so that's what made me put that
song
together.
It's about the hustle.
Yeah.
Being on that red carpet.
Yeah.
Do you like walking on that red carpet?
It was cool.
Good?
Yeah, it was cool.
What's it feel like?
I felt it was dope, but then it's like, damn, I ain't nobody. Like, you know, like
who do these people think I am?
I'm sitting here walking up feeling good, and then you have somebody like, oh, hey. Can you move to the side? I'm saying you got Miguel right in front of me. You got Pharrell right here. So it's like.
They do that to me all the time. Yeah, can you move over real quick? I got to get the shot.
It was cool, though. But it was dope. I got to, you know, get that feeling. That was my introduction to it. So it was dope.
Exciting. And you guys work together. D, you work side by side with this guy in the studio. Yeah. What's it like working with your homie?
It's good, man. It's good. It's a good connection. It's very easy working with him. He's not one of those artists who are difficult and come to you and say, hey, I need this. It has to be this way. He's open-minded, which makes it easy. Because I'm a musician, so I'm always trying to reinvent myself, and he's trying to do the same thing. So
who have you worked with? I mean, I know you've worked with a lot of big artists and stuff.
Well, of course, Tyron Brown, artist, Akon's new artist, Doze. An artist named
Shout
LAF.
Out to him. He's dope.
Yeah.
Is he dope?
Yeah.
Is he a singer, rapper?
He's a rapper.
He's a rapper?
He has a big joint on the radio right now. You probably heard it. Make it clap.
Make it clap. Throw that back.
A lot of artists down south. I'm originally from Tennessee. So
are you?
I have a lot of connections down south. And then a lot of ghost production. So, yeah. In contracts, I can't mention names, but a lot of ghost production. So, yeah.
You know, it takes a lot because, you know, being the producer, all eyes are on you because you're responsible for a lot.
Yeah.
So how do you handle the pressure when you're in the studio? It gets kind of crazy. It gets stressful.
Oh, all the time. Making music is a business.
Yeah.
I tell people that it's a job.
Yeah.
When you approach doing a song, you have to approach it at a different angle. You're working closely with the artist.
Mm-hmm.
So you're trying to understand what they're trying to, the picture they're trying to depict to their fans. So I think that's the hardest part about it. But working with Tyron, it's kind of easy because we're always on the same page. You know what I mean? So
he's like, we are.
And we both just don't.
You're drinking the same wine.
He's going to come with the humble, and that's cool. I'm humble too. But at the same time, I mean, he's great at what he does. I'm great at what I do. So you bring that together, and we bring better stuff out of each other. You know what I mean?
Of course. You bring the best out of each other. Yeah. That would suck if you brought the worst out of each other, you know? That would really suck.
Yeah.
All right, so how long have you been doing this for? I mean, how old were you when you were like, okay, I'm going to be, you know, a musician or a rapper? At what age did you go, okay, I'm onto something?
Fans screaming, throw their panties all around the place. Hey, yo, this your boy Trigg, and I'm back up in your face. I was in the fourth, fifth grade, me and my boy Jermaine, shout out to him, Miss Blaylock class. That's when I'll take it back even further than that. Like, my mother is a teacher, so she used to, I had a best friend in Englewood, and then, We when I moved from Englewood, we always kept in touch, and his mother was a teacher too. So they used to try to make us like write letters to each other,
mm-hmm.
and we didn't want to do that. So we would just like write raps back to each other. So that's how it started, like having fun with it. Then I started to like really write songs and stuff in the fifth grade. High school, that's when I started to like say, man, I could really do this, you know. Linked up with my dude, linked up with my peoples. Shout out the bro, Big Joe West. Was doing music with them. That's when I recorded my first song when I was 16 and whatnot. Then I fell back a little bit. I went to college, graduated college. You know, I was working 9 to 5 and I was waking up every day like, what the hell am I doing? Like, what is my life about?
Mm-hmm.
And I started going hard for myself in Las Vegas. And then like my mom hit me. She was like, Terrence, like, oh, I said my real name. I put my real name out.
Oh, shit. Watch out, Terrence Shay.
My mom hit me up and it was like, T, like, what are you doing in Vegas? Like, you need to move back out here and, you know, really, really go hard. So I would say, like, 2010 is when I really made the decision. And then 2011 is when I started really, really, like, putting in work and networking and stuff like that. Like you said, as far as handling business, like making music, everybody can make music. Hey, you walk outside on the street right now, you mm-hmm. pass by 30 people trying to hand you a CD. But 2011, that's when I really said, okay, I'm going to really get in this business.
Is that you playing in the background right now?
Yeah, that's me.
All right, let's turn it up. What's the name of the song?
This is the intro to my mixtape. And I think it's going off right now. This is the intro.
Woo!
Yeah.
Produced by D Night.
Nice.
I guess y'all ain't listening to it no more. This song right here though, it's called Dedication. I just released a video to it. It's shouting out to Floyd Mayweather. He's one of my favorite athletes. And I just appreciate he gets knocked for a lot of his arrogance, but I appreciate his arrogance because I feel like if you put in hard work and you really get as good as you could be at something and you prove that you're better than most of the people that do what you do, you have the right to feel good about yourself.
Definitely. Well, let's go to the call. I'm sure they're calling in for you. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
This is DJ Benjamin Walker, LA Hollywood area.
How you doing?
What up? Good.
What's happening?
I'm a big Tyler Brown fan. Had the opportunity to meet this guy in the club a couple of times, man. Seems like a real good dude.
Yeah.
So I'm going to come and show some love right now, man.
I love that. Do you have any questions for him? I mean, he's sitting right here.
You know, I guess my next question is, I mean, you got some mixtapes. I mean, what you got coming out? Obviously, I bump a lot of this stuff in the club. So, yeah. You know, I guess my next thing would be like, what would be your next hit that y'all have, like, on deck? I know you and D-Night produce a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
So, you know, what you got coming out, man?
Man, we working, you know? We just putting it all together. You know, we still promoting and pushing this mixtape, but trust and believe, we working on stuff, you know, all of the time. And when it's ready to be presented, we're going to present it right to you, brother. And we're going to have a knocking in the club like you did last time.
All day. I appreciate it. Hey, I want to say y'all looking real fresh in your Gucci V-neck t-shirts right now online.
I got the Nike sandals
on.
I want
to give y'all that love, man.
All right, man. Appreciate
y'all
it, brother.
Do y'all thing, though. Yeah. I love it. Tyler Brown, D Night, my boy.
We appreciate that. We appreciate all the love, man.
And shout out to BJ Walker too. He one of the flyest DJs out here in LA too, man. Yeah.
Dope. Very nice. All right, let's go to another caller. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
Hey, hello.
Let's go to another caller. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
Hello.
Hi. You're live in the air. Tell us your name.
Hey, what's going on? This is comedian Richard Taylor. I'm calling out of Vegas.
What up, brother?
Nice.
What's going on? I just want to shout out my dude, T. Brown. What's going on, man? I'm showing my support here from Vegas for you, family.
Man, I appreciate that. You are everybody already know, man. I love Vegas just like I love Cali. You feel me? So, you know, Vegas, that's still home to me, man. So shout out to everybody in Vegas, man. I'm out here, you know, I'm out here trying to make it happen, brother.
Well, we appreciate you calling and showing some love.
Hey, shout out to Richard Taylor, man.
Yeah, I had a few questions too for you, man. I got a chance. I did hear that the Road to Riches. I was bumping that for a minute. I really was. I was feeling in where you was coming from on that, man. The essence of where it was deriving from, man. Because like definitely. I said, I'm originally from Cali, man. So I definitely was following that. And one of my questions was, what inspires you, man, to make music?
Man, just I mean. To be honest with you, like writing was just always a talent of mine. Like not even just like writing poetry. Like I was always just a very great writer, basically because my mom kind of conditioned me to be that way. And you know, just being young and just being so immersed in hip hop. Like just when I was, you know, real young, just looking up to Ice Cube, looking up to Snoop Dogg. When I first got introduced to Nas, just the way he put words together, crazy, you know, and was able to tell a story. And, you know, it just brings me to another place that, you know, anybody who's out there that's passionate about anything, whether it's music, whether it's comedy, whether it's anything, like you just know, you know, that feeling that it gives you that nobody could take from you. You know what I mean? So. And I started to realize, you know, when people sit down and really listen to me, they really could take something away from it. So I kind of gave myself a responsibility, like, you know, you have to use this gift to the best of your advantage because you could really reach people with it.
Well, you're definitely gifted, man.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for calling in. We appreciate you.
Another one. Because I ask direct questions, you know, what do you think makes you, different from any other artist in the industry?
I'm not weak and I'm not fake. That's the two main things.
I'm not from LA.
And I'm intelligent and I'm handsome too. Like honestly, I just think like I got the full package. Honestly, it's nothing that I'm lacking. Like,
you're confident.
Yeah, I'm creative in a lot of ways, and I'm also innovative. I don't really sound like anybody. I kind of built my own lane, and I feel like, you know, especially being in the college market, I feel like a lot of the young ladies, like, they would really, really love rap, you know, but they just feel like they have nothing to listen to. So I feel like for those people who feel like they don't have nothing, they don't have nobody speaking for them, you know, I'm speaking for the intelligent person, you know, that really believes in themselves, that wants to make something, but at the same time is not corny or nerdy, you know what I mean? It's a lot of people out here that I feel like I speak for that haven't been spoken for yet. You know, I'm not out here wearing you know, purple shirts and, you know, and getting on, doing nothing like that. And, you know,
What's wrong with the purple shirt?
That's not me. That's for somebody else. And I'm not out here, you know, trying to talk about stuff that's been talked about 1,000 times. So, you know, hopefully
chain, gold chains and money.
Yeah, you know, I mean, that's cool. Yeah. You know, it's fun, but, you know, it's more to life than that.
Yeah, but people can't really relate to that, you know? Yeah. I mean, I do rap music myself, so it's like you can't relate to that because it's not everybody in the world is rich. Not everybody, you know, is going to the club every night. Right. So, I mean, keeping it, you know, new and fresh and real, I think it's the most important.
Yeah, I think another answer to that question, too, is I feel like I could really relate to people, like something, even if it's not the situation that's the same, you know the thought or you know the emotion in it, so you know that's
right.
Like that.
That's why when I heard the Road to Riches thing, I gravitated towards it because I felt that, you know, I'm an artist and I felt that the essence of where it was coming from, you know. So I big ups to you, man, on that, and respect to you on that. And actually, man, for everybody don't know, I'm shouting him out because I got a chance to perform with him out in Vegas. So he's not just in L.A. You know, he's known out here in Vegas, too. I got a chance to share the stage with you. I remember on the college scene, and, man, it was one of those nights. It was cold. It was raining. And, you know, like I said, I'm pretty sure you performed in front of hundreds of people, and you performed in front of 10, five people. But I'm letting everybody know this dude go hard. Like, he was, I mean, you gave me that. It was like the type of realness that Tupac had, man. You gave me that real West Coast.
Damn, that's a comparison.
Wow.
Oh my God.
And I'm a comedian, so I'll talk bad about you if you, you know.
Well, we appreciate you calling in, though. We really do. That's amazing.
You know, he was
amazing.
Coming with it. And shout out to you, man. Much success to you. God bless you.
Off tease,
all right, well, we'll talk to you soon. What's your name on Facebook?
This is Richard Taylor, the
awesome
comedian.
Well, thank you, Richard Taylor. Yeah. Thanks for calling in StarCam Radio. We'll check you next time. All right, we got to go to another caller real quick. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from? They hung up.
They hung up.
Got the fans
y'all
calling in.
Y'all
like
patient.
Tupac. Tupac.
Y'all impatient.
Tupac.
What's your turn?
Man, popular guy.
You know, he said he saw you perform in front of how many people? Hundreds?
No, well, that show that he's talking about, man, that was a heartbreaker. You feel me? Like, shout out to my boy, Sale M. Dot. Man, we put together a concert in Vegas, and, you know, we didn't get a lot of attendance, but it comes with the territory. Like, I heard, I can't think of her name, but the last young lady that was here, like, it's going to be disappointments. You're going to have good days. You're going to have bad days. You know what I mean? So that was a bad turnout, but we still, everybody that
you're doing it.
Yeah, we did our thing.
All right, let's go to the caller real quick. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
Yo, what up? This is Tim. Timbo the King. Tim Hatcher from L.A. Town.
How you doing? You calling for T?
I'm calling for both of them, actually. Well, first of all, I want to give a big shout-out to T. Brown, man. Something that when I met T a couple times. One thing that really stuck out of my head is that he was like, yo, I don't smoke, and I've never seen him drink either. So what keeps you in the studio? That's big, you know what I'm saying? Because in hip-hop culture, it's like, oh, you got to smoke, you got to drink just to be cool. Mm. And, you know, he's showing that that's not the case.
That's a good question.
What keeps you, you know what I'm saying?
Man, anybody that knows me from back when, like, I was a heavy weed smoker, all of that, you feel me? Like, and what does it do for you, really? Like, I don't know, like, I'm not, anybody that know me, like, I walk to the beat of my own drum. I'm not really no follower, and I'm not easily influenced, right? You know what I mean? So, I do what I feel like I want to do, you know, and I don't, I mean, maybe it's just a little bit of the natural.
So you're high of life.
That's what my mom say to my mom. I don't need that. You know, like I'm already outgoing. I'll be in my own zone. I'll be in my own world. I'm already random. And, you know, I'm a Gemini, so I'm already crazy anyway. You know, I'll just be chilling in. I feel like if somebody is gonna judge me for what I choose to do, you're not nothing anyway. You know what I mean? Like I just do me.
Nice. Well, we got to go to another call real quick. Thanks for calling in.
This is a phone conversation.
Yeah, this is phone conversation.
Y'all be finna be hot.
Hey, caller. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
We can't hear you, baby girl.
It's Leslie from Rialto.
Leslie from Rialto, my big sister. What it do?
How you doing?
Are you going to talk?
So, my question for you, brother.
What up?
When you're on stage performing.
And I'm on stage performing.
What do you feel? What's going on?
Man, I feel like I'm biting into a York peppermint patty, and I can feel the mountain. Nah.
The rush.
Yeah, nah. I feel like, for sure, like, this is what I'm supposed to be doing, because, you know, I mean, luckily for me, even though I've been in some venues to where it wasn't that many people like that, but I always rocked it, though, and I feel like, yeah, T, this is what you're supposed to be doing. Like, I've done a lot of things, you know, and I never felt like, I felt like I was wasting my time. When I'm on that stage, it's just the best feeling. You know what it's like when
I sit in the chair.
The world's supposed to be tuning into this white girl right here, and they're gonna know that, you know what I mean? Like,
oh yeah.
On me, like it feels like the best feeling in the world. Like nothing else feel when I'm writing a song. When I'm listening to one of D-Nice's beats that brings out an emotion and inspires me, when somebody hits me up on Twitter or in the street or whatever and be like, man, you know, you said this and it really got to me. When a girl said, ooh, yo, it turned me on, all of that, it lets me know, like, this what I'm supposed to be doing.
I dig it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna tell you, as your sister.
What up?
You know, I'm very, very honest.
Be honest.
So when I first heard about this, okay, T finna be out here rapping, I'm like, oh, Jesus. Like, it's going to be a gimmick. But I can tell you that I was pleasantly surprised. It was the very first time I ever saw you perform live.
That was at the Key
and
Club?
Every time. It
Were
gets
you shocked?
Better and better. So.
Were you shocked?
I was. Aww. I was. Yeah. I knew he could always write. I knew he could always write, and he loved hip hop, and he loved Nas, and he loved Tupac, and all these people. But I'm like, okay, what's he gonna bring that's different?
And I'll bring
and
that.
He doesn't need a gimmick. He didn't. He didn't have anybody. He had a DJ, himself, and a mic.
Like a normal, you know, rapper should be doing. Except now they got auto-tune, they got this, they got that. So you keep it real. Hashtag hard work, right?
Always, man.
Always.
I mean, honestly, like, what gimmick? I don't know. Like, I just feel like I don't need, like, I'm an animated enough person, and I know how to turn it on, turn it off, and. I feel like just me is a good enough selling point, you know.
I'm not
an artist that's lacking in the talent, so you know that's gonna speak for itself, you know.
Well, let's turn it up. What song is that?
I don't know. This not mine. It sounds dope.
Turn it down. All right, we're gonna take a quick break. When we come back, more in the studio. Who is that playing?
That sound like Dizzy Wright out of Las Vegas, though. He dope, man. Shout out to Dizzy Wright.
Raise a demon that's on lockdown. Got out and now he acting hostile. You threw away your opportunities. Nigga, that's a cop out. Not now. We can argue later. All in favor. Raise your hands if you deserve another chance. Fan of a fan, we sharing the same things. We see the bumps in the road. We smoke and we maintain. So I play my position with persistence, consistent with the flow. Nigga, we twisting up the dro. In this life of sin, through the highs and lows, trials and tribulations, you know how it go. I pray you niggas maintain. I pray you niggas maintain. Yeah.
Cause when shit get all bad and you watch the game change, fuck the bullshit, it's time to maintain. You gotta maintain. 2 hours early, rise and shine. No ride, catching the bus to be on time. No time for excuses. It's your life, you can't be stuck on stupid. I give them the Aquanaut, like I can't be without a job. Helping moms with the bombs, I mean the bills, I mean bombs is how they feel. But how I feel, don't stop the deal. See, when you go without a meal, you stop taking play for granted. We were strong when we was weak, that's why I pray before I eat. It's bittersweet when it's something you wanna keep. And if that nigga don't wanna help, fuck it, do it by yourself.
I got clout in this city. Blow for the ass, no drought in this city. No doubt in this city. If this is the life you're about, then get with me. I got clout in this city. Blow for the ass, no drought in this city. No doubt this my city. If this is the life you're about, then get with me. One love to my pen partners. Shout out to my bang bro. See, I don't do either one, but game recognize game though. Swerving in my own lane, so nobody slowing my hustle down. Only real ones in my circle. My pops taught me don't fuck the clan. See, I'm that type that's gonna take any chance to get on. And the type that's worried about it, this chick gon' answer your phone. Don't neglect to respect it. When you catch me outside, ride around from the west side of that LA to the south side of that Chi-Town. Connected. Anytime I step in, getting love in large amounts. So the second night I touch down, they rolling that red carpet out. Roped off in my section, partying with the owners. And standing outside, trying to bargain with the promoters. Looking lame and thirsty, you on these hoes too tough. As soon as they see me, at first take they shoes up. Stay doing too much, trying to bother me with your biz. Don't ask how I'm running shit, nigga. All you need to know is
I got clout in this city. Blow for that ass, no drought in this city. No doubt in this city. If this is the life you're about, then get with me. I got clout in this city. Blow for that ass, no drought in this city. No doubt this my city. If this is the life you're about, then get with me.
It seems like everywhere I kick it and everywhere that I go, people be congratulating but hating me on the low. Cause they see a nigga shining, so basically it's that glow. I keep reminding these niggas that I done made it. But in Miami they love me, and out in Vegas they know. But if I want it, I'ma take it. I'm out here chasing my dough and waiting for no one. Patience is something I lack the most. So any one of you motherfuckers that's taking shots can't have a toe. Y'all just mad cause it's obvious that I'm everything that y'all wanna be. Playing for the title and y'all getting cut from the summer league. Hoping to be my rival, but niggas don't stand no chance. Cause I'm the nigga in my city from Melrose to Rosecrans. Getting big on a daily basis until the day that I wanna stop. Every block that I pass by, they treating me like a gun for rock. Anything that you got, if I need that, then I'ma snatch it up. I'm good anywhere I'm at for one reason, and that's because
I got clout in this city. Blow for that ass, no drought in this city. No doubt in this city. If this is the life you're about, then get with me. I got clout in this city. Blow for that ass, no drought in this city. No doubt this my city. If this is the life you're about, then get with me.
Check the highlight clips, I spit them full.
Plus I bite the heads off pit bulls. No barking from the dog, no small. And lil' mama cooked me breakfast with no hog. I'm somewhat more vicious than old dog.
Still to the society, I'm menacing.
My watch out of this world turned me to some type of monster like Ben Tennyson. Your girl is somewhat subpar, tennis is in. But I still jump off in your nine like I'm Racer X. Grab your pretty woman and make her pay for sex. Direct deposit only, no paper checks. Mainly cause my name ring bell like I got a humpback. Thus I spray the flow off the top of the head like a humpback. Keep y'all posted like a thumbtack. I ain't even fell off and I'm already making my comeback. Super fly like I'm fresh out of the Comic Con. Riding around with T. Even though I'm Islamic, I'm trying to keep myself from falling off doing Ramadan. I know these kids don't listen to me like automatons. I'm gonna let them know.
No, I'm not Mr. Rogers, but yes, I'm just as nice. Wanna die, die to live. I'm Jesus Christ. You ain't gotta say thank you, cause the disciples that I bring with me is mainly gangsters. And most of the lords around here is almighty vice. So I spit surgically 16 scalpels in the 16 chapels with no whitey Christ. And no false image of God, just imagine my squad. It's like a mix between the Lord and heathens. Anybody excited about running up on good music must be bored with breathing. There's important reason I turn the water to wine, cause niggas' daughters is crying.
Yeah. Sweet when it's something you wanna keep. And if that nigga don't wanna help, fuck it, do it by yourself. But put in effort to better your situation. If not for y'all, then do it for the baby. The system crazy. Whether you got you a son or you a daughter, don't run away from your problems or your partner. Maintain. I know it's getting hard, but it gets harder. You gotta understand that's the shit that makes you a man. So I play my position with persistence, consistent with the flow. Nigga, we twisting up the dro. In this life of sin, through the highs and lows, trials and tribulations, you know how it go. I pray you niggas maintain. I pray you niggas maintain. Yeah, cause when shit get all bad and you watch the game change, fuck the bullshit, it's time to maintain. Gotta maintain.
Gladly, do the snappy on my nappy. And the razor with itch in case a nigga try to clap me. I ain't a killer, but for Skrilla, it gets nasty. Pop up on the wrong night, get popped like mad acne. It ain't no coming home for you, homie. This phony brother with these rhymes over time will turn you phony. I see niggas making money, becoming dealers. Dealing pound the squillers, then give the beast out until he dealer. And get some real up for real. Niggas that take your life, you won't even get life for the steal. And if your grill gets formed. Blow out your funds and leave it as a warning. For informants, I feel like a dormant. Ain't kidding, can't take the heat, get out the kitchen. It's things for soft guys like you, like knitting mittens, kissing kittens, stitching snitches, whispering. This is daddy, wish you had my bitches and my riches. Punk, nigga.
Play my position with persistence, consistent with the flow. Nigga, we twisting up the drug.
King Punk.
In this life of sin, through the highs and lows, trials and tribulations, you know how it go. I pray you niggas maintain. I pray you niggas maintain. Yeah.
Welcome back, everybody.
Hey.
Hey, welcome back to StarCam Radio. I'm here chilling with D, and I also have another special guest who is a singer-songwriter, LP, in the house. I am LP on Twitter, right?
Exactly.
Welcome.
Thank you.
You want to say bonjour to all our friends?
Yeah,
he's French.
Are you French with it?
Yeah, he's French with it. And we also have Tyron Brown in the house who is going to perform a little something.
On the break, on the break, she was like, we got to get you to perform next time. I was like,
yeah.
What's good with next time? Let's get on right now.
So, D, you created this beat, you produced this beat, and you brought it here today.
I'm hearing it for the first time, too, y'all.
Yeah, Tyron, he haven't heard the beat yet. I don't know if you guys remember the Black Rob. So,
okay.
Whoa. So I took that song and I kind of twisted it up, made it, put up the D-Night drums, D-Night sound, and, you know, we'll see what Tyra can do. You know
awesome.
What I mean?
And we also brought on LP. He's a singer and songwriter. So I figured we make it like the... Like kind of
like
the
show.
It's like it's like the messed up view. You know what I'm saying? Or like it's like The Voice or American Idol.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? All right. So you had never even heard this beat before.
No, this is gonna be
off the top.
Nah, I'm gonna start it with a rhythm, then we're gonna transition it off the top.
Are you gonna use lyrics that you've written down before? Or is
it just from the top
of the head?
It's gonna be both. It's gonna be a little bit of both. Y'all gonna tell? I ain't gonna lie. I don't.
Awesome. What are we gonna name this beat? I mean, name this song. D. What would you call this?
Gin.
All right, you ready, LP? You excited?
I'm ready.
Let's get you close to that mic. I can't hear your French voice.
Whoa.
All right, so I'm ready. That's good.
All right.
Whoa. Hey. 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 Look. These Napoleon niggas be having issues, cause I'm that 6'5" nigga that y'all just wish you was. Never showing bitches love, but I treat the ladies well. They be flocking to me cause I'm fly, and they could tell that most these niggas fake as hell. Deep inside, you know it's true. Let me explain in detail why they choosing me or you, cause my face look better and my Better y'all be trying to cuff them and I just let them do whatever the fuck they want. I ain't the one that's gonna hold them back. Some strange reason that they be leaving them so attached. I eat it and own the cat, then beat it and blow it back. Then she treat it like a frisbee and she just throw it back. Whenever they hit an AT Brown, the girls be getting wet. Whenever you bring your ass around, they show you disrespect. They got that collar around your neck cause your chick made. Girls been throwing me they since the 6th grade. But I'm just chilling, posted on the radio. Every day we go and play these, and we get the dough, and we stack it right. I just live that active life, and trying to live up off this show money. Chilling with Jen, that's a bad snow bunny. The ladies say that they want the dough from me, and I just laugh and tell it, no honey, you so bummy. You's a broke chick, and I don't quit, I just go spit. And my dough gets bigger on a daily basis. That's why the ladies always throw me all these crazy faces. You basic, and I'm just chilling. I'm trying to make a million like a track that I recorded about a year ago. Hit a flow. I eat you sweet like cereal. Yo, flows off the top though. I don't really know what you got, but it's not dough. Deep night up on the track. And we just do it like that. I'm chilling, I could go harder. Cause your bro smarter, and I go farther. Like a running back, I want my money black. I need it grown. Yeah, and I belong on the top of every list that MTV could put out. From the hood route, I chose to stood out. I don't know what that meant, but I don't really care. It don't gotta make sense, cause it's all off the top of the dome. And I'm strong on this beat, and I'm blown. No, I'm not, cause I don't smoke weed. How much more time did she say she was gonna give me? She said she was gonna switch the beat, get back on it. And I don't give a fuck if it's tight, I'ma rap on it. I'm trying not to cuss, but I got a bust. It really doesn't matter, cause in God I trust. So, he know I sin, and I'm chilling with Jen. And this is all off the top, I didn't use no pen. Okay, hey, hey. I'm sorry, yeah, Mr. Jackson. Yeah, okay. Okay. Hey.
Mamas, mamas.
Okay.
Baby, mamas, mamas.
Hey.
Yeah, go like this.
Shout out to Andre 3K. Yeah. Okay. Good. Okay. 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 Good. They threw me off with this beat, but I'ma still spit. And everything I do, it be real shit. In elementary, they said I look just like Will Smith. And I said, damn, that's real sick. I wish I had his chips, though, cause that dude is rich. And I don't give a, I flow tighter than Ludacris or T.I. I be fly, see why these hoes try to be on me. And they be like, hey, what? I don't know, I'm just chilling. I don't really like this beat, but I'ma keep killing. Yeah, I'm not feeling that one at all. Yeah. Okay. Okay, I'll mess with this. Yeah. Okay. Hey.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do one for the ladies real quick. Okay. Look. Baby, hold up a minute, just had to let you know. Don't usually give attention, but something special shows. And you, that's intriguing all of my curiosity. You turned it down, okay. Hey, baby, hold up a minute. Just had to let you know. Don't usually give attention, but something special shows. And you, that's intriguing all of my curiosity. I was thinking you could talk to me, or maybe possibly we could figure out if this is more than just the usual. From the way you staring at me, that feeling is mutual. It's apparent we share attraction, and it's growing strong. Cause since I saw you, you're the only thing my eyes can focus on. Now, am I wrong for approaching you like that? Been so long since I met a girl who come close to what you have. I'm digging this conversation, don't wanna come to an ending, but I'ma keep it up front and let you know from the beginning. I'm not the type to talk for hours on the phone about them niggas from your past and how them cowards did you wrong. Let's move on, we both had situations, so let's not even care. Past is in the past for a reason, so let's just keep it there. Yeah, I plan to give it till it get you upset, so get used to me licking every single inch of your flesh. Become addicted like meth, gon' mess around and overdose. Leave your body shaking like you was catching a Holy Ghost. Whoa, baby, hold up, I'm talented more than sexually. I'ma be that nigga that challenge you intellectually, give you conversation and help accomplish your goals, and be be there to pick you up when you felt you lost your control. I know you deal with thirsty dudes, it really comes as no surprise. Expect these girls, roll their eyes. They gonna be coming at you with issues, that's true. But the reason they gonna do that is cause they wish they was you. And I do notice you don't really have to search for confidence. I know that I'm the shit and you seem like the perfect compliment. So don't have second thoughts, baby girl, just take the ride. Who knows where we gonna end up, forget it. Let's just let fate decide, right? Hey, that's just to show the ladies, I do got a heart, ladies. You know, a lot of ladies try to say I'm a player and all of that. I'm not none of that. I'm a nice young man, you feel me? Okay. Okay. And look, all right, I'm going to spit this verse. This is a song D-Night was just talking about called Workflow that we got coming out. Look. Hey, hey, no time I got to spend. Stay working, never clocking in. You want my advice on how to win. Treat your grind like it's oxygen. Then get it in while they asleep. 7 days a week, don't be afraid to speak. Can't tame a beast that's ready to do whatever it takes to eat. Good music, BBE, you damn right, the whole squad with me. D-Night, he's CP3, and I'm Blake Griffin, that's Live City. Bash, we out here making a splash. Last year we put in a work, this year we taking the cash. Nigga, making money, I'm about that. Take it from me, I doubt that. And these rats after my cheese is gonna get caught in that mouse trap. Wes, I shout that, get your mouth slapped if you disrespect. These niggas cut from a different cloth, cause they always talking so indirect. Putting on for that left coast of my guys repping that Tennessee. Picture me with some freaky girls that got bisexual tendencies. Licking these, sucking those, these hoes be with it. They hit me to do this song and I said off top, bro, let's get it. Yeah, yup. Hey, with a singer out though, LP, I'm challenging you to a singing battle.
I'm gonna do better than that. I'm gonna challenge you in rapping in French.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Get it.
Let's get it.
Here or here?
Yeah, over there. This is like, wait, let's get one more. This is like BET 106 in Park. They're gonna battle with that right now. LP hey, in the house.
I feel like he about to kill me.
Yeah.
I feel like he about to kill me one time. Comment allez-vous?
Hey, mec, ça va bien. T'es prêt là? Vas-y, approche-toi, vas-y. Attends. Can you restart it just for me? Just for me. Yeah,
what did you just say?
Yeah.
This is great.
Yeah.
We're gonna start from the south. This is LP official.
Exactly, it's LP.
It's LP in the house.
Just for you, Jenny.
We're gonna drop your new track, by the way. Keep it simple in a
Thank
little
you.
Bit.
You're okay.
Welcome.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be your hype man too.
Yo.
Yeah. Bosse plus dur qu'une montagne à l'horizon, mec. J'avance si vite que je crée ma propre saison. T'es pas calibre car je suis top du béril. Est-ce que je transmets, c'est du broadcasting. J'suis tellement à la mode, j'suis bagnole de Givenchy. Même en fond de nous, t'as tête au pétale avec Harry. Toujours à la une, comme une star de Hollywood. J'baisse les meufs de mon groupe. Ici à Bollywood, mec. Des mots qui pètent Eton. Mais c'est pas du Preston. Partout spa, chat Eton, ça résonne. Mon crew est unique, il a titre comme Benetton. Et moi, j'fais tête comme un Armani Collection. Oh my god, it's been a long and long rap, but it was just for you, little split. You know what I mean?
To be honest,
hold
I wouldn't even
hold
know if you messed up or not. You know what I'm saying?
Bonjour. She paid for the money because I don't know.
Yeah.
No, you did that. You did that, my brother. You did that.
Well, let's get you back over there. We're going to talk to you real quick. We're not going to perform. Don't worry, buddy.
I got killed in France.
LP, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good, and you, how are you?
Fantastic. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Welcome.
That was dope, by the way. I don't know what the hell. You could have been cursing at us all. Like, you can all die right now. We're like, yeah, boy.
I got too many French people listening to me. I cannot curse. I got to
scream it at me after that. I can't.
All right. Well, welcome to the show. You're a singer, songwriter, actor.
Yep.
And we're going to be dropping your track, Keep It Simple, tonight.
Okay.
Dane's World. We got Keep It Simple ready to rock. Do you mind if we rock it right now?
Yeah, please do it.
Please do it?
Please do it.
Let's do it. Big round of applause for Tyron Brown, by the way.
Hey.
We're going to play this new song, LP. We're going to take a quick break. Actually, should we take a break or should we talk about the song? We're going to take a break. Let's enjoy the song, Keep It Simple. LP in the house, Tyron Brown, be nice.
Simple, I don't wanna argue with you, cause we're fighting. what you say. We gotta smooth things out our way. Just an impasse that won't last. We can overcome, babe, when it's over. No one will say mistake twice. Wanna make love like we used to do. I want to talk, settle it down. Do you like to cause I won't let go of you? You got a CCC, the better than that. You're from shade, but I can wear that. Ooh, I love for you, you know I love for you. Let's keep it simple, I don't wanna argue with you. Cause we're fighting all for nothing. Let's keep it simple, you know I'm into you, girl. You're gonna get through.
I swear that she can get it. Say if you a bad chick, put your hands up high. Hands up high, hands up high. Tell them dim the lights down right now. Put me in the mood. I'm talking about dark moon perfume. Go, go.
I recognize your fragrance. Hold up, you ain't never gotta say shit. And I know you taste this a little bit, high maintenance, everybody else basic. You live life on an everyday basis with poetic justice, poetic justice. If I told you that a flower bloomed in a dark room, would you trust it? I mean, I write poems in these songs dedicated to you when you're in the mood for empathy. It's blood in my pen. Better yet, with your friends and them. I really wanna know you all. I really wanna show you off. God, pour up plenty of champagne. Cold nights when you curse this name. You called up your girlfriends and y'all curled in that little bitty range. I heard that she wanna go and party. She wanna go and party. Don't approach her with that Atari. That ain't good game, homie, sorry. They say conversation rule a nation. I can tell, but I could never write my wrongs lest I write it down for real. P.S. You can get it.
And I know just what you want. Poetic justice, put it in a song. All right, that's a little Kendrick Lamar. Welcome back to the show. God, I feel like the Kardashians would be really jealous of me right now. Have three black guys in the house.
I need what's the oldest one's name?
Chloe?
No, keep it real. I need Chris.
You need Chris?
I need Chris Jenner.
Alright, well, we got LP in the house. We got Tyron Brown and D Knight. We also got a caller on the line. Let's go to the callers. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from? Hello? Bonjour? Hi, you're live on the air. Tell us your name.
Hello?
Hello?
Can y'all hear me? Just breaking up.
We hear you. We're not breaking up. How you doing? Man. Welcome to the show. How you feeling?
Y'all almost got T-Mobile like me.
No, we got that. Hey, what's
happening? Hey, this is Big Joe West, though.
What's up, Big Joe West? How you doing? You have any questions for our celebrities?
Is this? I'm calling for Tyron Brown. That's Tyron Brown.
Yeah.
Tyron, what's happening, my nigga?
My G, what's good, bro?
Is that okay to be called that?
Okay. Oh yeah, man. Hey, man.
Say whatever. I'm just wondering.
This dude on the phone that y'all hear right now. This is a dude. I've been writing, but like I said in high school, like this the dude that
allowed me to come to the studio, you feel me, and really get better at what I was doing.
Is he a producer?
No. He's an artist himself. Oh, okay. He's super dope. Y'all check out the bro Big Joe West and the Young Giants. You feel me? But this is the dude. I shout out to you, dude, cause you made me a lot better. You already know it ain't even nothing to be spoken about. You already know.
Is he on YouTube?
Yeah.
It's all love, man. You know, I'm just calling to support, man. I'm happy about what you're doing and keep smashing. I've been trying to call in for at least 6.5 minutes. You know what I'm saying? And man, I'm just showing my support, homie. Keep smashing. You know how I go, man. And keep smashing and lyrically thrashing these dudes, man. You know how it go, man. We ain't gonna stop, man. Only way we could go is up, player.
We taking off. Hey, y'all. Check it out. Tyron Brown, Big Joe West, produced by D-Night, coming at you real soon. Taking off.
Yeah.
Nice.
Hell yeah. So you know we taking off on, man. Oh, man.
Awesome. We'll have to have you on the show one day.
On records and in person if they tripping. And shout out to D-Night too. You hot boy. Keep keeping them beats. You know them beats popping. I be listening to Tyron Brown mixtape all the time, man. And hey, keep it smashing, homie. You hot.
I appreciate the love, man.
You think you're hot,
the
love. By
you
the
already,
way.
You already know, G. And keep smashing, man. I just wanted to call, show my support. Because it's Mando. You know how it go, man.
Yeah.
Well, we appreciate the love. Thanks for calling in StarCam Radio.
All the time.
Awesome. All right, welcome back, everybody. It's been crazy. We got performances. We got callers. And we also have to welcome our special guest who's joining the panel, LP.
LP.
How you doing? That song we played on the break was dope. The song we just played. Tell us about the inspiration behind the track.
Okay. I'm all about relationship, you know, and I think sometimes we discuss too much. We have too many arguments. So I was just trying to spread a message and say, you know, take things easy, keep it simple. That's the idea behind the song.
I think you do great at the Jersey Shore. Like, you and Snooki would just, like, hit it off.
Oh, don't tell me.
I'm from Jersey, so I know they love that type of music.
Okay. Hey, if the homie Marcel listening, that's what he want to play at his club.
So what kind of, how would you describe your sound?
My sound, it's house music.
House music.
Yeah, but I have a hip-hop background, but it was getting older. I really start to have a really attraction for the... For the house music.
Of course.
And this is where I went after that.
You also can rap in French. I mean, we had Tyron Brown perform, and then you went up there, and you, I don't know what the hell you said, but you sounded great.
Thank you.
StarCam Cypher.
Got the StarCam Cypher. Yeah. And I also got to give a shout-out to my boy, Shaquem Williams. I was just talking about him.
Yeah, you
producer, were. Radio host, entrepreneur. Welcome, Shaquem.
Shaquem, we need to do some work, brother.
We got to get in the studio.
Yeah, all that.
Shaquem, let's get you on the mic, bro. Okay, buddy. Yeah.
Hey, Shaquem, you look like Will I Am, bro. I got to put that one out there. I couldn't hold it in.
I wish you could turn the cameras on him.
Yeah.
But you guys can call us up and join the conversation. The phone number is 323-247-7443.
Hey, picture Will I Am from Bompton. That's what he looked like.
He's such a talented producer and singer. This guy is like the definition of like talented.
No.
Shaquem, how you doing, buddy?
One, two, one.
I don't hear shit. He's testing 1-2. I don't hear anything.
Testing 1-2.
No. You guys having a good time or what?
No, I'm having an excellent time. It's good.
What do you guys do when you're not in the studio? How do you guys? What's like? What do you do when you're down? Want you like your downtime and stuff?
Work out. Hoops, read. I actually read a lot.
Okay.
Yeah, I got a degree in English and journalism.
You think so. Like we're like surprised, like we actually read a lot?
You would be surprised. People
really?
Think, yeah, people, when I tell them like, oh yeah, I actually read, they're like, oh, you read? Like they don't think people still read, like I'm an avid reader, so. Yeah.
Okay, well you're a producer, so you have to be smart, knowledgeable, you know your stuff.
Exactly.
What do you do, LP?
Wow, I'm doing many projects, so I got acting project I'm working on. And
yeah.
Music. Walk out too, and traveling.
Very nice.
When I have time to travel, I travel. I love it.
How long ago did you move to LA?
2.5 years.
Two years ago?
Yeah. 2 years ago, yeah.
Oh, very nice. Well, welcome to LA. Do you like it?
I love it.
You love it?
Yeah.
The weather's amazing.
It's amazing. Even when you wake up, you get this blue sky. It's amazing. I love it.
Do you work on your tan a lot, or?
What do you mean?
You work on your tan? the weather, I mean.
He doesn't
you like house music.
Ah. You see that?
I see that. And you're also an actor. You have a web series you're working on right now.
Exactly.
I get on an episode, dog?
Yeah, we got to check out the show. It looks great. I saw it on YouTube.
Yeah, it's interesting. So it's like it's essentially a concept between like the barrier, the language barrier, and I talk about my situation in my life about that. The communication between two people when you come in the country, you don't speak the language, you have to learn, you have to communicate with people.
Mm-hmm.
It's good. Yeah.
I know, it's like what we're doing right now, you know? Yeah, this barrier.
Yeah, it's a barrier and it's not getting broke. I don't know what you're saying, but I'm going to just say, for sure.
Yeah. But that's exciting. I mean, is it hard? Do you have to turn on an English accent? Do you have to be able to, you know, or do you have the French accent?
I have the French accent.
Oh, you do? Very nice.
Heavy, strong French accent.
Don't change, bro.
I try. I will.
Don't change.
I will not.
People want me to lose my accent. I'm from New York, so I'd never want to. I will.
Word to my mother.
Shaquem, in the building. Dane's World. What happened? I can't hear Shaquem. By the way, we have a panel of very talented people in the house.
Yeah, we do.
I feel surrounded. I feel lucky to be in a one room with very talented people.
You'd ask me what I do on my free time.
Well, you know, I pretty much know. Okay. Rap, hang out.
And I watch Star Cam.
You watch Star Cam? Yeah.
And I like
what
to,
do?
You know, I like to... I like to plant trees and
very nice.
And paint. And, no, I'm just playing. I just like to work out. I'll be at the 24 on Slauson, dunking on fools. Catch me in there. I just like to hang out, like to write, chill, play dominoes.
What's something your fans don't know about you?
Something my fans don't know about me. Something they don't know. I'm not really tall, man. I can't keep this lie going. I just wear pumps everywhere I go.
You're like Tom Cruise with the little wedges, the secret wedges.
I'm really only 5'3", man. Nah. Honestly, something y'all don't know about me is a lot of people hit me up like on Facebook and Twitter. They be like, oh, I know you probably don't pay attention to me, but man, look. I don't know. Some of y'all think I'm Jay-Z. You know, that's cool. Keep thinking that. But, you know, I appreciate everybody that, you know, takes the time out to listen to me, man, because y'all don't know how much y'all influence me. Like y'all might see me going crazy on Facebook writing some random stuff, but y'all comments and y'all response and even when
your Facebook updates, you're like Oprah.
Yeah,
sometimes
I say some crazy stuff too, and I get some girl from Tucson, Arizona or something like, you shouldn't say that. But your perspective like helps me write. So all of y'all, like I really be just paying attention to the world. Y'all all help me write. So I appreciate that.
What about you, LP? What's something your fans don't know about you?
When they check my Facebook, what I was doing really in my life, I think it's really two different sides because I'm more calm. I like to hang out home. But when you check my extra life, it's things from home.
You look very social.
Yeah, me too though.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you guys are just kind of like chilling the couch type of dudes when you're not...
Yeah, man. I lived in Vegas for 6 years, man. I did it all. You feel me? So I'm chilling now, man.
What about for the ladies? Are you guys single or are you guys available? Anybody available or can we talk about that? Or what about you? You available?
No, I'm taken.
You're taken.
Shout out to you.
Are you taken? Are you married?
No. She don't want to marry me, but
you wouldn't marry her though.
No, I'm just joking.
How does that make you feel?
What does that make you feel? She just want to marry you.
No, I'm taking.
How long have you guys been together?
It's about to be 3 years.
Congratulations.
Thanks. Yeah, I always tell people, like, people, fans always ask me, oh, you're in the music game, all you know, celebrities. I always tell them, like, I have the same chick, same whip, just a new crib. That's about it.
I love that. You know, because my boyfriend is actually a musician, and he says the same thing. Like, they think because you're in the music industry,
yeah,
you know?
I date Megan Good, or I hang out with all these. Nah, I hang out with the same people I went to college with.
But you're humble. Tyron,
yeah, like, nothing's changed.
Everyone should be like you, dude.
Because
I've seen a lot of people that are not
don't
like that.
I with none of y'all.
What about you?
This guy's always at my house.
Man.
Single, dating?
I'm single, man. I'm trying, though. Like, mom,
are you trying to find a girlfriend?
Mom, I'm trying. Granny, I'm trying.
You're trying to get married.
I'm trying.
You should go on The Bachelor.
But man, a lot of girls are honestly intimidated by me.
Mm-hmm.
And,
why? Why is that?
Man, I got that track record. I got it.
What does that mean?
I ain't gonna lie.
Explain.
I got some miles on the car.
Well,
you know. But it is what it is.
Wait, let's go back for a second. What does that mean? I mean, you had some miles on the car. Let's talk about that real quick. Shaquem, welcome to the show, by the way.
Well, thank you very much.
What
thank
do you think that I means? I have to get into a man's mind. I do a segment called The Men's Room. What does it mean when you say you got miles on the car?
Man, you feel, I was young and dumb.
He's smashing and dashing.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, LP, what do you think that means?
I really don't know what that means.
He doesn't know what's happening.
No, I know what's happening, but I don't know what that means.
Yeah, I don't know what that means either.
No, I didn't. You know, I've been around, but I'm trying to change my ways. And honestly though, the real answer to that question is I talk to D-Night about it all the time. Like, I'm just so focused on what I want out of life. I'm not gonna allow anybody to come distract that. And you know, a lot of girls, like, they need a lot of attention that I'm just not able to give.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of y'all girls out here, y'all got babies, y'all smoking cigarettes, y'all just doing bad.
So you just need somebody on your level, somebody that can keep up with you.
I need somebody who has a radio talk show. just messing with you.
If I could say so, I think the position Tyron's in, it's just hard to find a woman who can not be intimidating and accept what he's doing, but also be a support system and have her own life.
Yeah. And also have their own shit going on.
Yeah, exactly.
I know what you mean.
It's hard.
And that's the type of girls I'm attracted to, honestly. Like, because you had to, you said you got a boyfriend, right?
Uh-huh.
And he understands what you're doing, right?
Yeah,
He understands how hard you have to go and how demanding it is and how you have to really dedicate yourself to it to be able to stand out from everybody else. And if he didn't understand that and he was like, well, just stay home or just...
I've had ex-boyfriends just like that.
And where are
controlling,
they
controlling, obsessive. They're nowhere to
exactly,
be found.
Exactly, you know? It's like, I want... Not that I know Barack and Michelle Obama, but I'll be trying to pretend I do. But it's like, I feel like when he was on his come up, I feel like, you know, she was like really like ride or die for him. Like, you know, you got it, Barack.
You need
a
ride or die chick. We should play that song.
Get up there and get on point.
All right, let's go to that caller real quick. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
I come from France, Ludo. C'est Jean-Philippe.
Oh, my God. Welcome to the show, buddy. How are you doing? Are you calling for LP?
Thank you. I'm fine.
Calling from France?
Yeah, I call from France.
Oh my God.
Lucky.
Comment tu t'appelles?
We're international, huh?
Jean-Philippe.
How are you? Are you calling for LP?
Yeah, I'm a friend of LP.
Any questions for LP?
Oh no, it's just to say hello, my bro.
Thank you.
And, thank you very much.
Just what? For the radio, your microphone is off, Ludo.
Well, we appreciate you calling, and we got to get to another caller.
Thank you, bro.
Thank you. Hey, caller. Tell us your name. Where are you calling from? Hello?
Caller.
They must be calling from France.
Maybe.
Hello? Yeah. Bonjour? Comment tu t'appelles?
Jean-Philippe.
Parlez-vous français?
I think it's the same person. No?
How you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Thank you for calling. Are you calling from France?
Yeah, from France.
Oh my goodness, our second French caller. How are you doing? Tell my friends and my family in Strasbourg I said hello. Okay, we have LP in the house. Are you calling to talk to LP? All right, well, we love you, French guy. Dude, what a night. We got French callers. We got a bunch of callers calling in. We got a really talented panel going on here. Shaquem.
Yo, Jen, I was once again.
Yeah.
You know, I was listening to your show at the crib.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, let me go ahead and come on in.
Yeah. Like, I love it. I was just talking
always
about you.
Off the chain. Every time, you know, your star quality that you attract all
Shut
the
up.
Time is the bomb. You have to give it to you every day, all day. And we have to give you this right here.
Woo!
For being awesome. Give her a nice round of applause. But how you doing today, Jen?
You know, it's so good to see you because for 3 weeks I've been sick. I had bronchitis, I had a sinus infection, I had the flu, I had the bird's flu, I had like everything.
Oh, you contagious?
No, I'm good now. But we were supposed to get into the studio three times.
Bird flu.
And I had to cancel on him like three times because he's like, what's wrong? I'm like, I'm sick. And then I go to the urgent care. I'm like, I got bronchitis.
Can't talk, but now you got your voice back. You
Woo!
Look bubbly.
Let's do it.
You look real bubbly right
thank
now.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm not even drinking bubbly, but I feel bubbly.
Right, I know.
I should be drinking bubbly. But, you know, of course, I was telling D-Night about you. He's a producer, artist,
okay.
Tyron Brown, LP. they're all artists and, you know, very talented. So I was talking about Shaquem, and then he shows up.
Yeah. Wow. Look how the universe always works out.
I know. We always drop beats, and we just rap, and we just vibe, and we just rap, and we vibe, and we rap. Yeah.
Just do it, and that's how we do it.
Should we drop a beat? I feel like we should just drop a beat.
See, and I want to hear Jin Get Off, man.
Well, you can play my rap track.
Oh, yeah. Please. I want to hear your
I want to hear it. Yeah.
You want to hear my rap song?
Please.
Shaquem, do we have that in the file somewhere?
Well, let's go in.
Let's go into the JT library.
Let's go to the JT
library. By the way, people, hit me up on Facebook. It's Jennifer Tapiero, and I'm also on Instagram. I take good pictures.
And she always posing.
Yeah, I'm always posing. Radio Girl Jen Tapiero.
Y'all gonna see the one I'm about to post right now.
Yeah, it looks like I did glamour shots from the sixth grade.
What is your Twitter name so I can?
It's at Jennifer Tapiero. I got a lot of people on there that are hacking me. Like, oh, because I buy Twitter.
Yeah, because I got followed by like that Radio Jen or something like that. I thought that was you.
Oh, on Instagram?
Yeah.
That was me.
Oh, okay.
LP, what's your Twitter?
It's LP Official.
Awesome. I'm pretty excited that we had your French fans and friends call in.
And I'm actually surprised because I think it's 9 hours.
What time is it over there?
It's like maybe like 3 hours.
You're looking at your clock. Are you still on...
niggas in Paris.
What time is it in France?
I think it's... should be here. Now it's like, I don't know, maybe it's 3. 3 or 4 in the morning, something like that.
4 in the morning?
Maybe, yeah.
They're listening to your house music, fist pumping out
exactly,
there.
Exactly.
They can't sleep.
Mm-hmm.
So, are you going to be in the studio anytime soon?
Yes, yes. But my main focus now, it's my... I get back in shape for my video clip. We shot it, my video clip, the 3rd of April.
Uh-huh.
So, this is my focus right now. Get back in shape and be ready for the video.
You're going to kill it.
I have to.
Do them hip-hop abs.
So, yeah. That's my main focus
That's
right
your
now.
Focus.
Yeah.
And you got the web series going on. So, you're doing big things, buddy.
Yeah. I work a lot.
Huge.
I work a lot. I try to do my best.
Congratulations.
Wake up again. Wake up every day and be busy.
What time you wake up?
7 in the morning.
7 in the morning.
Yep.
All right. Well, we got How to Love in the background, actually, playing. Hey,
that's your song?
No, that's not my... That's actually my boyfriend singing the cover of Lil Wayne.
Uh-huh.
Oh, this is adorable.
It's cute. What? He dedicated it to me.
Oh.
I can't wait. Shaquem,
you looking in the files?
I'm looking in the file and I don't see your song. But
it's 3 minutes, 12 seconds.
Hey, baby, when I'm looking in your pretty eyes, sometimes I have to realize that you were ratchet.
Let's talk about that. What the hell does that even mean? That the word, honestly, I think that word, when girls say that word, it's disgusting.
It's disgusting.
It's not good.
Okay, all right. Are you in the club scene a lot?
Never.
Okay.
You should ask LP that if he's
I was trying to explain to you what a ratchet is.
Man,
you
like
ratchet,
disgusting or nasty?
No, a ratchet, I would say, is a thirsty female. That's the best way. When I say thirsty, she is...
A leech?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay.
She's that girl. You know, you see the girls at the club that
come around when you have a bottle of
Grey Goose. You got a bottle.
$400.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You can be the ugliest dude, but you got 5 bottles. Mm-hmm. That girl's on you all night. Oh, I'll go home with you. Them the ratchet ones. Them thirsty ones.
This is what I want you to do. Take Sepulveda to Slauson, turn right on Slauson. Go about a mile down and then just get out the car, put on Bands and Make Her Dance. And then all the ones you see out here go, hey! Honestly, and that's where I live at too. So let me stop talking. Shout out to the show.
I know what you mean though. But what's it with guys like that? They get this bottle. You can literally buy that bottle at CVS for $36.50.
That's you.
It's $400 in this.
Thank
you. It's right. The whole luckily for us, we don't got to really worry about that. You know, because that's part of our job. You know what I mean. So I'm not spending $400 for Nathan bottle, but I don't know. Honestly, I wish I could really explain it to you, but that's just not how my train of mind thinks, you know. But shout out to people, you know, that
is the new one
that validates them and that makes their life important. I don't know, you know.
Yeah, sometimes
just ratchets just stay away from your boy.
I put it like this. I'm from Tennessee, so coming to California and going to the clubs is different. Down south, we can bring alcohol in some clubs. But out here, for guys to even get in the club, they got to buy bottles.
That's true.
So
oh
my God, I see what's going on out here.
This is me rapping right here. We'll see
what happens. All right, let's get off. Yeah, I'm the hype man on this one, too. Alex.
God's gift to me, yeah, Messiah. Sex is wearing me out. Oh boy, I'm tired. I'm tired. And we just getting started. We so fly. Oh, the plane just departed.
Hey.
The champagne. Bacardi, all your haters said to me.
No matter where we go, I'm tour. See us coast to coast, we taking on. More than just a fling. Do we let's hope this thing? And I never felt like this before.
If you try to hate the haters, be quiet.
Yeah, y'all dead like Ed Hardy. So check it out. We the life of the party, and her body so fine like a bottle of Bacardi. And I'm saying we never on time, we just fashionably tardy. My girlie's riding shawty, she's so fly, you call her Marty. And we getting kinda rowdy, we shawty up on the track. And I love her so much, and I love how she love me back. She the best.
So insane, all love, no games.
Y'all better catch up, we
and
in the fast lane.
No matter where we go on tour, see us coast to coast, we taking on.
Now haters,
be quiet.
Y'all be jealous, we pulling up in the Bugatti. Nice body, chilling with my hottie in the lobby. And I kiff him, my man. Yeah, I'm talking John Gotti. Baby, yeah, you hotter than Tabasco. A mad flow, you love it when I shake my ass though. Sticks and stones will break my bones, but the haters will never find.
And no matter where we go on tour,
we gotta drop a beat now.
Yeah. Is that your boyfriend singing on that? Mm-hmm. Hey, well, first, when he was rapping, he described the ratchet perfectly. Any girl that's still out here wearing Ed Hardy, ratchet.
Yeah, are we back? Are we back on the air?
Oh, we're not on air?
We're in the air now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, Ed Hardy's so dead. So it's like people like that. Like.
Yeah, if you still wearing Ed Hardy in 2013, ratchet.
Shout out to Krishna and Jay.
All right, well, welcome back, everybody. This is Star Cam Radio. We're chilling with D Knight, Tyron
shout
Brown, LP. Who we shout out to?
I said shout out to Krishna and Jay. I go to some of his parties, so can't.
But what we like to do on Star Cam Radio, we like to drop beats and we like to rap. So,
let's get off.
Should we get a topic going? We got to get a topic.
Ratchet.
No, I don't even know what that means.
Let's talk about
Shaq Kim will sing a little something. First of all, you gotta hear Shaq Kim sing something. Yeah. You got him. Come on. And LP will be in there rapping in French.
Yeah, it was actually cool doing that. I like it.
That was dope, by the way. You should get yourself a little track doing that.
Yeah. Get off first, Jim. Alright, we're gonna talk about
Montana. Nicki Minaj.
What you wanna talk about? We're gonna talk about.
Yo. What are we gonna talk about, Tyron? You start off. I gotta vibe.
Okay,
up
let's see. What do I want to talk about, man?
What do I want to talk about?
Yo. Look, a young dude that ain't taking shit. Girls say, why till you can't get in relationships? And I say, cause you really ain't worth it. I ain't buying you no nails. I ain't paying for purses. None of that. Give my money, run it back. Music, ain't nothing in front of that. Me and D Knight, we can stay up for 3 nights. Make some dope shit, not drop it down on that me site. This is off the top of the head, this that shit I needed. The girl say, T, why you so conceited? I say, cause I look in the mirror and say, damn, I'm the motherfucking man, and I can do what the fuck I want. I don't smoke weed, nah, I don't need that blunt, and I don't need that drink. What the fuck you think? And I'm roll around with 20 in the tank. That's how I stay, keeping these hoes with no gas. I don't give a fuck. They treat me like I got no class, but I do. I graduated, and I did get faded back in the day. But that's all that I can say. When I'm chilling on this beat, he look like Willie Am. They say how much you work. I say like 4 million, but I really got like 10 in the account. Pass it to Jen, and now I'm out.
Yeah. Yo, I'm JT, man. I'm so fly. connection so bad, I call this Wi-Fi. So watch out when I slap by, hey. So hot like watch out. I make you sleep like a lullaby.
Hey.
Yeah, I'm chilling with LP, yeah, and D Night. Man, I'm so fly, man. Yeah, I'm so white.
Hey. You gotta give it up for Chad. Oh,
hey. Yeah, hey, get off, LP.
So
get
white, but I got that space. Yeah.
Hey, get off.
Show me LP, French. Show me French. What's up? Bunch of motherfuckers.
Personne ici t'a compté sweet. Quand je t'attends, je la tête qui tourne vite. Ce que t'as fait pour moi, ce que t'étais pour moi, t'as toujours été là. T'es mon amour, toi.
Tiens,
de couleur miel. Mais les frères, les frères, moi, t'as fait ma tête. Oh,
bah. Oh, bah. That's what they say when I come around. And if y'all want a trip, the homies come and gun you down. I kick it with some real ones. And I don't really give them. I'm not the one to steal from. Cause you can't, cause you not as smart as I am. And not as talented. They be like, damn, you fly as hell. How do you balance this? And I say, man, my only challenge is I don't know what rhyme with it.
You such a stunner. Okay. You sure kill it every time. Love you in the summertime. Love you in the wintertime.
Hey.
Love you with your suit and tie. Love you when we wine and dine. Connection so hot, we call this wild. Yeah, we chilling with the LP. We rapping
good,
French, and I don't know what the hell he say. Yeah.
Hey.
But we're not playing. Chuck him.
But we're not
change
playing.
Put a number 33.
Hey, yeah, I need some turn up.
Number 33.
I'm gonna spit some deep shit too for y'all. I need y'all to know.
Get it off your mind.
Let me see.
Yo. Yeah, pulling up. This is
gotta get deep on this. Okay, this your beat?
Yeah.
Oh, this
you wanna get deep on something?
Yeah, let me get deep real quick. I gotta show him. What's the
topic though? How deep are we getting? Like emotional? Like you might cry?
Let's see.
Yeah. Young Honey, LP, Tyran Brown.
This is some shit I just wrote. Look. I had a bad day, so I'm laying up reflecting. All this doubt is filling my brain up with questions. Nobody probably knows that I'm going through depression. My mama said that's the door for help, start showing you direction. So I try, but I can't lie. First thing that come to mind is my best friend that's dead and gone. I know my head is strong, I'm just trying to figure out what's next thing. And if that's all that she wrote for him, I don't understand this shit. Try to stick to the main script, but it's hard to dream. Ah, this shit going too
fast.
Hold on.
Let's get some French.
Yeah, I need some.
Let's get some French in between there. Cause it's so fun.
That shit was fast as fuck, y'all.
No, get it. Go back and do it and have him rap in French.
Let's try it. Yeah.
Go back and have him rap in French. Okay.
It sounded like I was speaking French.
Okay, ready? That's you. That's all you, man.
Uh-huh. Okay.
No, go back to that fast beat.
Damn it.
You want to go do the fast beat?
Yeah. In French. I think that'd be hilarious.
Let's try.
Okay, and then after you should tell us what the fuck you're saying.
I will.
Was that a stone?
Was it this one?
No.
Yes.
That's slow as hell. Young Moolah, baby.
Oh, yeah,
you feeling LP?
I try.
He can literally be cursing at us, and I'm like, that's just hot.
Let me get off real quick. How will life turn out these next couple of years? Will I have a job or will I have a career? Will I be a boss or just be one of my peers? Shall I be on top or lost in all of my peers? My fears got me scared that I'ma end up like a fool. Didn't have a clue what to do when I was finished up with school. I got a 9-to-5 and then pretended it was cool. But in my mind, my price and my potential isn't getting used. Confused, had to light the fire candle to the flame. Like different weights with a strain, I couldn't handle all the pain. This road to riches is very hard to manage and sustain. Like overdosing on cocaine, it's doing damage to my brain. Understand I can't complain. This the path that I chose, the biggest passion I showed. Cause I'm giving that from the soul. Nowadays, a lot of fake niggas gassing their flow. They getting up in this game, just get distracted by hoes. I do neither of those. I'm motivating, teach lessons. Any doubt that I ask, gotta answer for each question. I ain't about to be stressing. Go out and seek blessings. Every day I keep lessons in order to do how I do. Dedicated.
Dedicated to the love, but life, and the fun,
okay,
of the fucking game.
Hey.
Shit didn't change.
Hold up.
Rearrange my name.
Hold up.
Hold up. Hey, yeah. Now, these people coming at me because they're hopeless. Woo. Doing anything they can just to distract me from my focus. Too many chances to sick attack me like some vultures, but they're envious as hell, and that's exactly what I noticed. Because before this, these losers ain't ridiculed. But ever since the day I refuse to be typical, they find it difficult to give me my acknowledgement. They'd rather talk a lot of shit and spit on my accomplishments. But that's how it goes. I continue to feed them. Now I know why Pop said, in the end, you don't need friends. And fuck associates, I only need supporters. Instead of 100 pennies, I'd rather have 4 quotas in my corners. Fuck taking orders and anybody.
Let's get Frenchman on here.
Je bosse plus dur qu'une montagne à l'horizon, mec. J'avance si vite que je crée ma propre saison. T'es pas calibre car je suis top du béryl. Et ce que je transmets, c'est du broadcasting. Je suis tellement à la mode, j'ai des bagnoles de Givenchy. Ma meuf porte du loup, ta tête au pied, t'as le Beccari. Toujours à la une, comme une star de Hollywood. Je baisse les meufs de mon gros wood. D'ici à Bollywood, mec, des mots qui pèsent étonnent. Bah, c'est pas Preston. Partout je passe, ça t'étonne, ça résonne. Mon crew est unique, une attitude comme Benetton. Yep. Et moi, je vise et tête comme un Armani Collection.
Killing them. Bah. Hey. That was a total collaboration.
Buck.
Comment allez-vous, bitches?
Wow. That was hot right there.
Jean, you
that
got
was
one?
Hot. Yeah. That was so hot.
Jean, you got one more for us?
Check him. Let's play another beat.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, the French guy kills
I'm
it,
surprised
man.
I didn't
know what the hell he's saying. I'm like,
I really wish y'all could see that he looked like Will I Am, dog. It's really fucking me up.
Yo, turn the cameras on Shaq
Him. Don't he look like Will I Am?
No, I don't.
back in the days, though, that's the joint.
We have to do a collaboration. Days. We got LP and French, Tyron Brown, okay. D Knight, Shaq Him, myself.
Okay, yeah, listen. Hold on. I'm trying to target these markets. Stay sharp through darkness. It's hard, but my heart is large. I'm an artist in charge, regardless of all this involvement causing a conflict of conscience. These monsters constantly contemplate bringing answers. But let me get back to me. My mind keeps moving rapidly. The only honest student, that's that motherfucking faculty. Actually, my life is a vision of what I had to see. Laugh at these rappers who say they out to murder wacky seeds. Bitch, we grown men. Better get your dough, bro. Time moves fast and go win, going with slow-mo. That's why I'm on my solo. Cause don't nobody understand that staying down for long is exactly what gave me the upper hand. I tell my fam, I ain't trying to be with the gimmicks, but then on the other hand, they reminded me this a business in your image. The shit that can lead you to all your fortune and it's unfortunate torture when they force me to be porcelain. But truthfully speaking, it's a loser we're usually seeking. I used to be reaching for the stars, but this journey has placed me on Mars. My scrapes and the scars, and the alarm is awakening me while I'm trying to escape from the arms of the devil that revels in the glory of distorting the story of my worth. And then purposely put these hurdles before me to sing. It forced me to think the thoughts of a typical person working to get them a certain version of life. Playing all day and slaving all night for some type of wisdom from Christ to help him vision the sight, or at least giving the right type of wisdom so they'll be winning the fight.
Woo!
That's my life.
That was hot.
Hey.
How do you breathe? Like, do you take it like a breath?
Well, with I mean, I practice so much. Like, a lot of people think you just write a song and rap it. I spend all my days, like, it don't matter what I'm doing. Like, everybody be like, T, you always zoned out. It's like, no, I'm not zoned out. I'm just always rehearsing and constantly.
Do you rehearse in the mirror, or how does it work?
Well, no, I usually just stare at myself. No, I'm just playing. Wherever I'm at, I just be zoned out. Like,
that was so sick.
I appreciate it.
That was dope. LP, you ready for another French battle? All
right. Let's get the French in this.
I love hearing it in English and then his translator in French.
Okay.
Okay, come on, LP. What are we naming this one?
Wow, okay.
Name it, I don't give a shit.
I don't give a shit?
Yeah.
Okay. That's a good topic. I'm going at the top when you get on.
All right.
All right. We're having a good time here, by the way. Star Cam Radio, I'm holding this down at the LA Talk Lounge. Restes
visite, petit suis-toi. Quand je pense à toi, j'ai la tête toujours été là. T'es mon amour, quoi. Tes yeux couleur mille, mais les frères frêles. Moi, t'as fait ma santé, la meilleure personne. Dans une boîte, je t'ai vu. Moi, je t'ai reconnu. La beauté de ton âme à travers toute ma vie. On parlait, on rigolait. Le temps qui s'enlaçait. Les rires, tant que tu vois ton sourire. Ce soir, on va s'aimer. Ce soir, on va s'aimer. Tout le monde se redescend, on va se mettre à danser. Hein? C'est pas fini, yeah.
He's like Pitbull when he's done.
Yeah. Okay.
Star Cam.
Yeah.
Jim, get off. For you now.
French guy, are you kidding?
Star Cam.
Yeah.
I don't give a shit. Don't like me. Bite my dick. Like that. Like crack. Oops. Did I say something I was supposed to?
It's okay, you can curse me.
Oh, it's good.
Excuse your French.
It's okay. Oh, yeah.
We got the
word!
We got
the
word!
Let's go, my French! Look at the
You!
What?
That's your turn.
That's me?
Yeah, that's your turn.
What?
Get off.
I want another one.
What?
I want another rap.
Get off.
Yeah,
he wants you to rap.
I'm always rapping.
Get off. Okay.
I don't know about this beat.
I want to hear you on like a D Night beat though.
Now we're here on a D Night beat.
Hey.
I bought some beats for y'all.
Hey. I was like, yo, Trey.
Let's play it.
I can do my Nicki Minaj voice.
Can you please? Can you play that Thuggin beat, please? I need to spit my verse to that.
Oh, the Thuggin beat.
Okay.
D Night, get your Thuggin beat. Well, we got a few more minutes left of the show, so we can do whatever the hell we want.
We got a few more minutes.
Hey, ladies.
We got a few more minutes.
Hey, everybody, follow me on blackpeoplemeet.com. Lonely in Los Angeles. No.
What's your Twitter, by the way, if we want to interact with you and everything?
Hit me on the Twitter, man. Tyron Brown 247. Instagram Tyron Brown 247. Facebook Tyron Brown. Man, hit me up. I swear to God, I'm always out here. I'm either saying something uplifting, or I'm making you laugh, or I'm offending you. Whatever it is, man, you're gonna love it though, man. Just keep up with me. And I'm gonna be in here posting pictures too, man. And if you on Instagram and Twitter, man, hit me up. I'll shout you out.
LP, if we want to keep in touch with you.
LP Official on Twitter, LP Official on Instagram, LP Official on Facebook. You can Google me, LP Official, you find everything.
That sounds so Hollywood. You're only in here for 2 years. Google me.
Google me.
That sounds so Hollywood.
It's easier, you know?
Yeah. Find me on Google. That's how you gotta come. Like when girls try to act arrogant, you be like, man, I'm on Google.
You can Google me.
At Darno Night.
He's only here from France 2 years. Hey. He tells me, Google me.
Hey.
No, I told him, Google me.
And we're going to check out your web series, by the way. Very talented.
Hey, what's the name of your web series, bro?
The Barrier.
The Barrier. Okay, cool.
The what?
The Barrier.
The Barrier.
Don't make fun of me.
I don't know what you're saying.
I said the Barrier.
The Barrier.
Yeah, the Barrier.
Oh, the Barrier. Oh, the Barrier.
Yep.
Okay, we're definitely going to check it out because I saw a little teaser and it was dope.
Hey, Jen. And then when I'm done with my verse, I want you to get off. This is a song I'm working on. It'll probably be on my next project. It's called Arrogant.
Okay. I'm not arrogant.
But everybody got a little bit of arrogance in them. But look. Hey, I said, ever since like preschool, these losers show me jealousy. I'd never be like these dudes. They move not in my pedigree. Wonder how I got to act in this way and develop these thoughts. Well, maybe it's because the ladies is always telling me I'm so fly, flow tight. Right and eat them good, plus educated and uplifting and smart as hell, but still keep a hood, but then dedicated. When I'm up in them, I go hard as hell, so they stuck. Then they go back to their boyfriend, they realize that nigga sucks. I know few folks who can endure the shit that I go through, and that's probably the main reason why I'm sure it is what I hope for and wishing. Somebody helped y'all with y'all vision, but me, I just bossed up and put myself in that position. And y'all bitching, and I know they see me winning, really hurts, I understand. And these girls is after my pocket. I swear they worse than Uncle Sam. Every day that passes by, you're starting to get clearer. Only time I'm satisfied is when I'm looking in the mirror. Hey.
I knew you were going to say that.
Hey.
I knew you were going to say
Come
that.
Come on, get off, Jim. Come on.
Lyrically, grammatically, man, you couldn't mess with me. I'm high up life like I'm chilling up in the Hennessy. So you look at me, you best believe. Better than Nicki Minaj up my sleeve. I'm like in that underground track though. Bitch, yeah, now watch your back. I'm chilling back in the LA Talk Live studio, doing like I never did, like a rodeo. I'm like, I don't know what I'm gonna say, but let's keep going. Rap so fast, you can't keep up. Bottle, I don't give a fuck. The Kardashians be jealous of me because I'm chilling with a bunch of black people, you see.
Okay. Hey.
Yeah.
You messing with me, then you rolling with the winner. Everybody stuck on Kim, but I need that Kris Jenner. Cause she got the plan, she know that I'm the man. So if I see her, I'ma be like, Kris, you gotta understand that me and you together, we could get this cheddar, go through a lot of endeavors, and we could go wherever on the planet. But we ain't using minds, cause you got all the money, but I'll give you my time, but it's all good. This a big world that we live in, but it's small. And I don't really care, my fans, I do it for y'all. And my fam, I promise we gon' grow, and they gon' be like, T.
You high man, up on that rope.
Nah.
Yeah.
Is you high up off that drove? I said no. Is you slow? Bitch, to the top, I got to go. It don't stop, for sure. Yo, Jen, come take it and show them how you better than these other girls. That's basic.
All those bitches basic. No, those other bitches are faking. They lacking what I'm doing. They just trying to keep up with my pacing. I'm patient, impatient. Yeah, you got that facelift. I don't know what I'm fucking saying, but I'm just like rapping because we playing. Yeah, we in that slow mo. Oh, shit, we up in no ho. I'm like, no mo. I'm in slow mo. promo. Okay. Chilling about that mojo. I got that drink in my cup.
Hey.
Motto, don't give a fuck. Got what? Lipstick Turn on up. My cup. I'm Turn just up. Feeling kinda drunk.
Hey.
Rapping off the mic.
Okay.
Shaquem, have a rap or something. Yeah.
I wish I could rap.
Oh, about to okay. wrap it up though.
Hey.
A little something, Shaquem.
I wish I could rap.
Yeah, I was like Trey. I was hey. Like, yo, Trey.
Yo.
Do you think you can buy me a butter of rosé? Okay, let's get it now. All right, guys, we had a good time.
Had a good time, man. Shout out to Jen. Hey, but aside all the having fun, man, y'all really got to keep up with Jen. This is a young lady that's out here going hard, and keep up with her, man. A lot of you young ladies could get some real good inspiration off of her.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank Appreciate you for having that. Us here.
D-Knight, you killed it with all the beats.
Thank you. Thank
Big
you.
Round of applause for D-Knight, everybody.
Everybody out there, man, all my artists out there, from R&B singers to rappers, whatever you do, D-Knight got it all, man. Hit the bro up. It's worth the ticket. You know me?
Awesome.
How you Versatile.
Big round of applause for Tyran Brown, who's so freaking talented. I mean, flowing, performing. I would love for you guys to come back anytime.
Don't say that, because I'll be here every day. Like,
talking.
Like, Jim.
You know, we're right by LAX Airport. There's a lot of security around here, so, you know, just in case.
Man, hey.
And we got LP over there signing autographs already. So far, he's so Hollywood. He's signing autographs. He's telling me to Google him.
He got people
Hollywood
from
is going
to
your head, my friend. All right, LP, thank you very much for stopping by the show.
Thank you to have me.
Hey,
it was fun.
When y'all catch me in the streets out here, just say, whoop, what he do?
And a big round of applause for all our viewers out there for checking out StarCam. It gets crazy. And a big ups to Shaquem Williams, who has a show on Fridays. Tell us about it, Shaquem.
Every Friday at 8 o'clock, it's called The Shock Factor. We talk about music, we talk about politics, and we talk about music, but mainly music. You know,
awesome.
Talk about yeah.
Well, we appreciate
like
you guys checking it out. Since
Thank
this
you,
is
Jim.
A live show, I cannot control my guests.
Hey,
talking
Thank
to you, LP.
Thank you.
Hey, go download that Hard Work mixtape. Me and Malik Youssef, 13 great songs. D-Knight produced 10 of them. I don't know if the camera's on me, but if it is, hard work.
Go that's check it out.
That's what Malik said. Tyron Brown, Malik Youssef, Good Music, Brown Bag Entertainment, D-Nizite on the Trizac. Let's get it. www.tyronbrown.com. Go grab that.
Definitely go check it out. I've listened to it before. I like love it. So definitely check it out. It's
what's
definitely
your,
the
what's
next
your favorite
thing.
Song on there?
The
again?
Red Carpet song.
Red Carpet Entrance. That's
Red Carpet Entrance.
Y'all go
that should
check
be my theme
out.
Song of StarCam Radio.
It should.
We can work
should.
On
hey, let's do that.
Should.
Hey, and look out for that D-Knight, Tyron Brown, Jen collaboration.
Yeah.
We didn't sign the contract, but I just said it right now.
So hashtag hard work.
Hard work.
Definitely. Well, Snow I want to thank everybody out here, and thanks for stopping by the show. And big ups and thanks to my sponsors over at the Byron Williams Salon, Alina Raza and Debbie Dumas, Lashfully in Beverly Hills for, you know, doing my lashes, Courtney Casgrove, also Moonstar, and this is sponsored by Planet Love Match. And I'll see you guys next time. Well, we also have my Twitter. You guys have to follow me on Twitter. I will pay for followers. It's at Jennifer Tapio, at StarCam Radio, at Star.
That was kind of ratchet. That was kind of ratchet.
Because people are paying for followers ratchet. Now. I got to do that, I think, unfortunately.
That was kind of ratchet.
Follow us on Twitter, and then hit me up on Instagram. It's your girl, Radio Radio Girl Jen Tapio. And Facebook me.
All that.
And that's about it. Can you leave it out real quick? Quick outro with the French?
What do you want?
Just wrap it out.
Another one?
Yeah, just wrap it out.
Okay.
Right to this beat.
Okay. Let me feel it. J'arrive en deux speed, on m'a dit qu'il y avait urgence. J'ai apporté un nouveau son pour faire la différence. Comme d'hab, ça va bouger, comme d'hab, ça va groover. J'en vois déjà qui hoche la tête pour approuver. Bienvenue à toi si tu sais pas, je m'appelle Busta. Black and West Side, Paperstack comme Buster Rhyme. Du hip hop, tout pasteur, frère, je suis pasteur. Au nom du père et du fils et du ghetto blaster.
Bitch.
Yeah.
Book.
All right, guys. Next up, we have Rona Bennett's show, Perspectives Corner. Check it out. It's at 9 p.m. She is Miss R&B. She's from En Vogue. So that's a dope show. And then check out my show, Just Chillin' with Jen, on Mondays at 1 p.m. See you next time. Bye, guys.
Yo.
That French, my friend. It's alright.
many choices of internet radio, and the staff and hosts of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk. Are you ready to enjoy the Maui lifestyle? You can have it all by owning real estate on the Paradise Island of Maui. Dennis Rush, a 22-year Maui resident and real estate broker, brings his wealth of experience and market knowledge to add value to your Maui real estate understanding, providing a level of service as unique and exceptional as the island of Maui itself. The magical island of Maui was voted the most exclusive resort island in the world by Condé Nast Traveler, and keep in mind, Maui is only a simple non-stop flight away. Hawaii Business Magazine Top 100 Realtors awarded Dennis Rush the 2011 fourth top realtor on the island of Maui. Go to www.dennisrush.com to view all of the amazing properties currently available in the Maui MLS system. Whatever your needs or desires, Dennis Rush will provide a private consultation for any Maui properties your heart desires. You will be in good hands. Once again, go to www.dennisrush.com. That's www.dennisrush.com. Contact Dennis today to start your Maui lifestyle now. Dennis Rush, proud sponsors of the Dawn Christie Show and LA Talk Live.